fans can't believe it.
It's your life I am, baby.
The streak continues. We're now at 7 straight days of sunshine in Edmonton since the World Juniors started last Tuesday. Today, the final day of group play. Canada-Finland for first place in Group A. Team Canada wearing their black jerseys for the first time in this tournament. Ridley Greig has been a difference maker from day one for Canada. They'll count on him even more today. And Finland, like the Canadians, 3-0. One of these perfect records will get its first blemish tonight. As we say hello, Canada, and welcome once again to the Summer World Juniors here on TSN. James Duthie alongside Bob McKenzie, 1995 World Junior gold medalist Jeff O'Neill, and 8-time Olympic and world champion Cheryl Pounder. And yes, we figured it would come to this. Yes, there have been some upsets and surprises lower in the standings, most notably Latvia finishing an impressive third in Group A. But when the schedule came out, we looked at it and said, yes, it'll probably be Canada-Finland for first place in the last day of group play, and that's where we're at. These two nations have won 6 of the last 8 gold medals at this tournament. The winner tonight maybe gets a slightly easier path to another one. Gordon Miller and Mike Johnson, get you ready.
Thank you, James. The question before this tournament began, Mike, was how would Canada's defense hold up? Well, it gets its first tough test this afternoon, and Olin Zellweger and Ottmann Sobrango will be front and center.
They will be, and they've been really good up to this point. They've emerged clearly as Canada's number one pair, and they've been good, but tonight they'll have to be better than that because they'll be challenged, and they complement each other really well. Kind of the steady, physical, calming presence of Zabrango, who played a couple years professional hockey in the American League, and he'll be challenged in his own end to be good defensively. With last chance, you'll probably see a whole bunch of Ratu's line, the number one line for Finland. They'll have to stop them, and then Zellweger, maybe a little bit more of an offensive player, skates the puck up, joins the rush, but also does a good job with his feet to defend as well. They play both around 20 minutes, the most amongst defensemen for Team Canada. They'll probably have to play more than that and play against the toughest competition they've faced so far.
So it's August 15th, not quite New Year's Eve. This was the New Year's Eve matchup in the 2021 tournament. Canada won it, but the Finns have beaten Canada 9 times in regulation at the World Junior Championship. James?
All right, thank you, boys. Let's have a look at Team Canada's lineup for this one. Dylan Garand, of course, starts in goal. A team tournament leading 965 save percentage over his 2 games. Donovan Zabrango leads all Canadians in ice time at 1941 a game for the blue liner. And Mason McTavish is the tournament scoring leader. 6 goals, 10 points in 3 games. The moment of the tournament so far, that brilliant Michigan goal by Kent Johnson. He also had a terrific first assist against Czechia. What do you think he has in store for an encore?
Well, right now, Kent Johnson is my guy, Jimmy. He's on my team. In order for it to stay that way, he has to forget about that play, as awesome as it was, and understand it's probably not going to happen again. Don't go out there looking for this type of play. It was an unbelievable moment, but what his job is the rest of this tournament, and it's going to be in his professional career, is to be an offensive producing guy in big time moments, and that play is only going to come around once in a while.
The Ottmann McTavish Berard line has had spectacular moments as well. 4 even strength goals in the last couple of games, but is there room for improvement as these games get bigger?
Yes, and there's no question that head coach Dave Cameron is challenging not only his top line of Mason McTavish, Connor Bedard, and Brendan Hoffman to be even better than they have been, which is saying something because they've been so dynamic offensively. But what he wants to ensure is that that top line, as well as the whole team, now that you're up against a Finnish team that is very good without the puck, he wants to make sure that there are good exits from the zone, they get through the neutral zone, and they play a more connected direct north-south game than they have against some of the weaker opponents.
We saw Ridley Greig off the top. He's been a spark plug throughout the tournament. Does his third line play a more pivotal role against these Finns?
Well, they certainly do. Now, this is a physical line. You know that they can play tough along the wall. They're effective on the cycle. And Ridley Greig is the driver. He is my guy, as he gets below the goal line. And And he just has that ability to separate and create in the offensive zone. He knows how to work away from the puck, how he gets opportunity. He actually leads in scoring chances off the rush. And then, of course, his timing, his ability to get to the mid lane of the ice, redirecting right there, right in the net. So very effective third line led by Ridly Gregg.
I don't know. I'm sure he's one of those guys, too.
And whoever has a good game today, you can pretty much guarantee on the post game, he'll be one of those guys. The winner of this game plays Switzerland in the quarterfinals. That much we know. Canada, Finland, next.
This is a paid advertisement for legal services. Attention! Veterans, their families, and civilian workers were potentially exposed to hazardous substances in the drinking water at Camp Lejeune. From 1953 to 1987, toxic chemicals from unlined landfills and storage tanks leaked into the soil and groundwater across Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune. Those who lived, worked, or spent time on the base, drank, cooked with, bathed in, and were exposed to the contaminated water. Exposure to these chemicals increases the risks for cancer, birth defects, and other health-related problems. In some areas, levels were 400 times what safety standards allow. If you or a loved one were diagnosed with a cancer or other serious illness after being exposed to the contaminated water at Camp Lejeune, you may be entitled to compensation.
Call Sokolov Law now for a free legal consultation at 1-800-581-0131. 1-800-581-0131. That's 1-800-581-0131.
Welcome to Edmonton on this Monday afternoon. It's the final day of the opening round of the World Junior Hockey Championship Summer Edition, and it's Canada against Finland. Two great rivals met in the gold medal game at the World Championship last spring, and now back at it at the World Junior Championship. Both teams come in with 3-0 records. The officials are Robert Hennessy of the United States, Christopher Holm of Sweden are the referees, Andreas Hofer of Germany, and John Ray of the U.S. are the linesmen. Starting a goal for the Finns is 20-year-old Levi Marilainen, the Ottawa third-round pick, played for Kingston in the Ontario League last year. He's got a 9.13 save percentage so far in the tournament, a 2-0 mark with wins over Latvia and Czechia in a shootout. And for Canada, once again, it is Dylan Garand, the 19-year-old from Victoria, B.C., is a fourth-round pick of the New York Rangers. A 9.57 save percentage leads the tournament so far. Antti Pettinen is the head coach of Team Finland for the second time, was an assistant coach on their 2016 gold medal team. Dave Cameron, the head coach of the Ottawa 67s, former National Hockey League head coach with the Ottawa Senators.
Wait for this guy, Ed. Stop. He's sneaky. He's sneaky. Hold on. I'm going to blow my whistle. Stick down. Here we go. No. Stay.
A hotly contested opening faceoff.
Not quite the usual pleasantries we've seen every other game.
A little more tension in the air as Zellweger plays it ahead for Ridly Gregg. As Mike mentioned, Canada is the home team, has the last change here. So it's Trent Zellweger and Sabrango back on the blue line. Brought up by Joachim Kemmel, the Nashville first rounder. 20 of the 25 players on the Finnish roster are drafted.
They have a stacked team, plenty of good players, and a potent first line.
Joshua Waugh plays it back across. The Finns got everyone. So basically, anyone who wasn't hurt is here.
And you can get a sense of what Canada is thinking with Dave Cameron. Ridly Gregg is going to be act as a bit of a checking line going up against Atu Ratu, who's been dominant for Finland.
Brought out now by Robe Järvinen, the Ottawa second-round pick comes slotting in. Järvinen feeds it back in front. Simon Taivo pokes it back. That pass almost knocked down. Simon Taivo whacks at it. Good chance for Robe Järvinen, who played for Belleville in the American League last year. Jack Thompson slides that back to Seeley, and Connor Bedard makes it off the glass, but that's knocked down and fed back in by Joel Mata. Finns open with a win over Latvia 5-1, and against Czechia got down 2-0 early. Marilainen struggled, but they came back to win that game in a shootout and beat Slovakia 9-3 behind 5 power play goals. Their power play has been lethal so far in the tournament.
Discipline will be key when you see an opponent with a power play at 60%+, as Finland is right now. And talk about the opening faceoff. That's one way to set the tone. I'm going to win the draw, run you right over. Hope you're ready to battle, because Ridly Gregg is certainly going to bring it that way against Ratu every time he can.
Kent Johnson with a faceoff in the defensive zone scored that lacrosse goal against Czechia in Canada's last win. Broke a 1-1 tie.
Tournament buzzing that goal.
Johnson for the face-off against Oliver Kapanen. His uncle is Sammy, his cousin is Kasperi. The whole family's played in the Finnish league at some point. His dad was a longtime Finnish league player as well. He's got a cousin in that league. Sammy Kapanen played until he just couldn't play anymore. His body, he left everything on the ice in the NHL. Long shooting, and Durant holds on to that little snow shower there from Samuel Hellenius, whose dad also played in the NHL and brings an equally large frame at 6'6".
He knew exactly what he was doing there. Can't call it a penalty because the puck was a little bit late in being covered by Garand, so Hellenius is saying, I'm just trying to get an offensive zone faceoff, but players know what they're doing. He can skate behind the goaltender, or he can throw some snow into the ear. But always, both of them, both Hellenius and Jukas around the goaltender. Now Dave Cameron's having a little chat about that right now.
It can be a penalty. It's rarely called, but if it's really egregious,
super intentional, yeah, they can occasionally, but that would be a strong call this early in the game.
Yes. Zach Ostapchuk comes up with a face-off against Hellenius, whose dad, Sammy, played 7 years in the NHL and played the 93 World Junior Championship in Sweden. Fired back in, that's almost deflected by Hellenius. As Lucas Cormier goes back, and the Finns once again intercept the Canadian clearing attempt, and again. And finally knocked out by Cormier. Finns have the only shot so far as Topi Niemelä goes back. The Toronto third round pick was the top defenseman in the World Junior Championship in 2021. Cormier for Del Mastro. Ethan Del Mastro from Freelton, Ontario, brings it back out. Snaps that pass and is broken up at center ice by Pudio. Cormier intercepts. He's taken out at center ice by the captain, Ronnie Hirvonen. Hirvonen swings that back, and it's picked up by Ruben Rafkin. Rafkin plays it out for Ratu. And after Ratu was straight up at center ice, right hand is Ridley Gregg. So once again, there's the matchup. Zellweger and Sabrango on defense with the Gregg line up front against this top line for Finland. And Zellweger brings it in. Owen Zellweger shoots up block. Bouncy puck goes back in front, picked up by Sabrango.
Question: Canada hasn't had to worry about matching lines at any point in this tournament. You don't want to throw your bench off or impart a passive mindset because you're worried about Rath. You want to respect them, but you want to make them play defense as well.
And Watt and Dufour, Canada's checking line, has 250 goal scorers on it.
It's a credit to them that they are good enough defensively to be trusted with this role.
Yarmonti tries to slide that back in, pick back out. Emil Salmi back at the point, shoots, it got through traffic, deflected, and Garand knocked out of it. Sabrango off the boards, once again, kipped in by the Finn. Yarmonti took down Sabrango, puck down loose, Yarmonti in, shoots, Garand save, rebound, fired wide from the point by Emil Viro. Good pressure with nearly going by Finland. Emil Salmi works in. Emil Salmi walks the line, plays it back across, centering pass, and just missed, looking for Joel Mata. Finns maintain possession again. Vera winds and shoots, and Garand scoops out away. Canada hemmed in here as Dufour picks it up and finally throws the puck to center ice. Over the head of Mason McTavish, icing waved off as McTavish got there first. Emil Salmi fires that down to the Canadian zone, and this will be icing against the Finns, who have the first three shots of the first period.
Canada gets caught tired, running around a little bit in their own end, forcing Garand to make some pretty good saves, and Emil Salmi head up, and that one tipped on the way in. Garand tracks it, but this one a little bit more dangerous as it's going above the blocker. Yes,
wow.
Gets the blocker down to take it away from Biro. And Garand, solid early. Did a better job moving the puck up the ice.
Johnson winds in. Can Johnson rink wide pass bounced away from Ronan Seelig.
Handle that firm bottom hand. Excellent pass. Missed opportunity.
Johnson again. Holds. Walks in. Crisscrossing there and drops it back. Dropped back by Thompson. There's Stankoven in the corner. Logan Stankoven. Heels back a couple of times. Stankoven, the reigning Canadian Hockey League player of the year, plays it back across. And now moved out by Oliver Kapanen. Kapanen's a Montreal second round pick in 2021. Finnish league this year. Also, their second leg as the Finns come busting in again. Drop pass for Brad Lambert with a shot. That's blocked by Seelig. Now back at the point. Here's Pudio. Winds and shoots. And the save made by Garand as he walked around the block of Stankoven and got a shot away.
Garandman's rock solid as Canada has been running around in their own end. He's trying to do a little bit too much. Maybe he could cut out of position. Stankoven, big slide out of the way. And good patience by Puccio. You see Garand working. That's an excellent save because he's looking left and the puck goes right. That's a difficult save when you get down, lose sight of it, and then have to find it on the other side of the pile. Garand has been sharp to start this game.
14:48 to go here in the first period. Canada still looking for its first shot. Sabrango up ahead for Wah. Puccio. We have not seen a lot of the McTavish line so far.
When we start talking about the passive mindset, Ratu comes out, you're matching up against him. Your best players aren't getting their usual rotation.
Puccio lays it back down to the Canadian zone. Cormier swings it back across to DeFore. Rink wide pass for Wah is picked off and brought in by Rafkin. The only undrafted defenseman on this Finnish roster. Spent a year with Windsor of the Ontario League a couple of years ago. Niemela back across for Rafkin. To Niemela. Bounces back to Sabrango. And across it goes to Zellweger. Up for Bedard. That bounces into the Finnish bench. 13:57 to go in the opening period. No score between Canada and Finland on this Monday afternoon in Edmonton.
A real hard time moving the puck up the ice and watching coaching staff try to diagram some ideas in the neutral zone. And what they were saying is that the two defensemen have been in line with each other. They need a greater hinge so that the second defenseman has the puck and can skate up through the middle of the ice instead of being forced to the boards where they don't have any options. So we'll see if they can make that adjustment. Have the defenseman in the middle of the ice, attack the middle, and then be able to distribute to the wings.
The McTavish line stays out. After the TV timeout, McTavish, Hoffman, and Bedard. Mason McTavish leads the tournament with 6 goals in 3 games. Wins that faceoff back to Del Mastro. It was a late addition to the Canadian roster when Damon Hunt was injured the day before the tournament began in practice. Hoffman kicks at it. Here's Bedard. Slides that back to Zellweger. Olin Zellweger along. Wrist shot score! Tipped in, put by Hoffman! And Canada's got a 1-0 lead! Brendan Hoffman strikes again!
That was close to the crossbar. We will take a look, but I think it's going to be just below as Hoffman on Canada's first shot on net. Tips it home. Good job by Hoffman on the forecheck. Turns it over, and then Zellweger, so good at walking the line. Drift one in, and Hoffman able to tap it down and through Merlinen. Now that one's going to be good, but it's going to be tight.
The officials are huddling.
And huddling is the right word there in a tight huddle.
Hoffman scored against Slovakia. His dad, Gary, look at that.
I know you don't want anyone to eavesdrop, but that's a little much. But it was Hoffman on the forecheck who turned it over. It's the first time Canada's gotten the offensive zone and hit someone and turned the puck over. And Robert Hennessy going over the Canadian bench. Now, Christopher Holm just said ruling on the ice was good goal.
So they're taking a look at it.
It was close. No, it's good. It's good. Won't take any long. It was close. It's within 4 inches.
Right.
But it's, I think it's pretty clearly 4 inches below the bar. Great shot by Zellweger. On his back foot, under duress, gets enough velocity. We've talked about that shot. Center net, mid-chest. Because when you tip it down, the goaltenders focus on the puck coming up and has a chance to find a hole. So, excellent hands by Hoffman, who's had quite a little journey in this tournament.
Yeah.
You think about in the pre-tournament game.
Against Sweden.
Against Sweden. He took a couple penalties.
Yeah.
Was scratched the first game of the tournament. then came in the second game, played well, got a bit of a promotion late in that game to the first line, McTavish and Bedard, and somebody was Joshua Waugh, and now it's Othman, and he's making him look good.
He knows
that decision.
He knows where the net is. He scored 50 goals this year for Flint in the OHL. His dad, as we mentioned, Gary, spent 11 years playing in Switzerland. Othman was a Ranger first-round pick in 2021, 16th overall.
Now, is he watching his goal, or is he watching some other play?
I think it's good.
He's watching the goal.
I think it's good. Yes,
he's watching
I think
the goal.
So as well. That would be too disciplined. Yeah, no, it's good. It's almost on the elbow of Marilainen. And I understand taking a good long look, but it should not take much longer than this. Canada able to make good on their first foray in the offensive zone, really, 6 minutes into the game.
Robert Hennessy and Christopher Holm are the referees who took a look at it in the penalty box. And here comes the call from Hennessy.
After further review, the call of the ice stands. We have a good goal.
Can he just go to the school of West McMillan?
Yeah, a little bit.
With a little mustard
on there.
A little flair? Okay. Running off and well done. Get to the front of the net. After starting the whole play with his forecheck. And maybe that's to free Canada up to start skating and playing because they've been on their back foot to start the game.
We had a chance to meet him and his dad the other day.
Yeah.
And, you know, he talked about maybe the physical side of his game being underrated. He likes to bring that element to it, maybe keep the flies off the guard a little bit.
I don't know if he'll keep the flies off, but he can certainly be a fly swatter because he can run around and hit and get involved and finish.
Native of Pickering, Ontario, just east of Toronto. Pudio bangs it high off the glass. Knocked down again by Thompson, kept alive by Johnson. Hit Johnson, back with Jack Thompson. Across to Sully, shoots, they got down to Marilainen. Now a quick chance for Stankoven to put that by. Johnson back on it. Johnson winds across the top, drops it off to Sully. In comes Sully, his rink wide pass is ticked away and moved up by Vaisanen. Callie Vaisanen, another Ranger pick, shoots that in, knocked down by Garam. A couple of guys who will see each other at Ranger rookie camp in the not-too-distant future.
See how friendly that interaction might be, or not.
Great wide pass for Sealy. And now Zach Ostapchuk chops it in. Chance there for Goshen. It's turned away by Marilainen.
That's better in the neutral zone.
Out at center ice, knocked down by Cormier, and Lucas Cormier slides that back to Ryan O'Rourke. Cormier to O'Rourke. Up ahead for Gauthier, who chips it down. Marilainen plays it up ahead. Bouncing puck, picked up now by Dufour, buying some time. Rick Whitey goes for Cormier, walking in. Cormier in, shoots, and Marilainen makes the save. Here's Niemelä with it. At the center ice, Finns had a wide edge in play the first 6 minutes of this game. Canada scored its first shot, the deflection by Othman. Emil Viro goes back to Detroit, third round pick. Feels like there's a couple of Red Wings picks in every game here as Greg moves in. Five of them in the Sweden-America game last night. A stack that centers it. That missed wide, chance for Zellweger, that's blocked. Brought back up by Greg. Ridley Greg. Steps around Kemmel and center the wall with a shot. Marilainen the save. And Ratu brings it back out and finds Hirvonen. That shift came against Finland's top line. As Dufour battles for it, the puck called offside at the Canadian line.
The best defense, good offense. And so really Greg's team line responsibility, creating some offense, make them play. And that is a really good look from Greg out to Roy. Gets a lot on it, just clips the shoulder of Marilainen. Joshua Waugh's had a quietly productive tournament.
Yeah.
As he's started the first line, but he's, you know, been moved off of that, but has managed to pick up 5 points in three games. He's doing something right.
With 51 goals in the Quebec League this year, 119 points.
And you would have thought that he would be on a checking line against Finland to close out the round robin. It's amazing how the team evolves over the course of just 1 week.
There aren't many unproductive forwards on this Canadian roster. Picked out by Mata. Plays it back at the point. Vero for Mata. Shoots. That's blocked by Thompson. Jack Thompson's away with Bedard. And Hoffman jumping in. Thompson works in. Fires and put that wide. He had Bedard with him.
Well, you could tell the second he blocked the shot, he thought, my foot hurts. And then I'm going to go with it, but I want to get it to Bedard. The entire time down the ice, he's thinking, when should I pass it to Bedard? Eventually, he had to take the shot as he got into a good scoring spot.
Hoffman chips that down.
Not sure I want it, but I got to take it, I guess.
Thompson did have 21 goals this year as a defenseman for the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds.
Yeah, strong game the other night.
Yeah, blocked a bunch of shots. Was Canada's player of the game against Czechia. Here's Cormier back on it. Now Johnson trying to dig that free. Here's Puthio. Plays that back across. That shot blocked on the way in by Tyson Forrester. Brendan Laughlin's second goal in this World Junior Championship has Canada up 1-0 on Finland here in the first period, the final day of the opening round.
See Jack Thompson back on the ice after blocking a shot and creating a chance. Whatever is going on in bumps and bruises, he'll be just fine with. And you see him step out. It's a good block right there. And now he's off the race. A bit of a tight 3-on-2. And Finley keeps deferring and deferring. And Vito lets him get all the way in there. As he takes the wrister and goes wide. But 20 goals can score from this spot. Oh, Marilina got a piece of that, actually. Just glanced off his blocker. That's a tidy shot. For anybody. Gotta pick it inside the post. Marilina, pretty good save.
Face off in the Canadian zone. Zach Ostapchuk will take it against Hellenius. He's one of the top face-off men in the tournament.
Ostapchuk hasn't played center all this tournament. So he fares in the face-off circle.
Scramble draw pulled out by Del Mastro. A rink wide pass for Ostapchuk. Zach Ostapchuk, Ottawa second round pick in 21. Broken stick for him. Victor grabs another and rejoins the play. Brad Lambert snaps that ahead. And that pass finds a stick of Yusuf Mayenpaa. Hellenius comes in on a stop check. And Cormier goes ahead for Cooley. Back for Del Mastro.
There it is.
To Cooley. So Cooley shoots. That's blocked. Bouncing puck in front. Daniel had his stick knocked out of his hands. That's going to be a slashing call against the Finns. And the first power play of the game will go to Canada as Hellenius goes off.
Team Finland, number 20, minor penalty slashing.
Finland does retreat in a passive nature once you get the puck moving up the ice, and they close in on Denoye, and it's both Lambert and Finland is chopping down as Denoye is going to look for the puck. You know, it breaks the stick almost in half there. Easy call to make. Canada's got a pretty good power play of their own. Kicking along at 50%.
4 for 8. Four different power play goal scorers for them. McTavish, along with Bedard, Stankoven, and Johnson, the forward. Zellweger's the defenseman.
Another different look with Bedard in the bumper spot.
Now Johnson shoots, and a pad save made by Marilainen, and it's sent back out. There's Bedard with it. Connor Bedard. Up ahead for McTavish. And Mason McTavish winds in. Gonna feed that back across. And the line is held. Great play by Zellweger. And a drop pass from Johnson. Zellweger to Stankoven. Zellweger. Back for Stankoven. Logan Stankoven. McTavish parked in front. Zellweger. Works it across. Johnson found that shot. Cued it back in the corner. Now Johnson knocks it down. McTavish feeds it back to Zellweger. Two clearing attempts. Foiled by the Canadians. Johnson walks it and fires it. Carolina makes the stop. Johnson pokes it free back in front, and the Emila finally feeds it out for Finland. Duran quick up for Bedard. That missed. Went right down on goal. It's no icing on the play.
Shot on goal, though. Still with Duran hurting his shooting percentage.
Here's Duran back with it.
So Finland basically said, we're going to let Kent Johnson shoot and not Connor Bedard. We'll take our chances. That's the first adjustment they made. Canada's got to make the adjustment from that.
In comes Ruby Gregg now jumping in. Splits the D. Gets a shot away. Marilainen save. Rebound. Score! Tyson Forrester on the follow. And Canada's got a 2-0 lead on a power play goal.
Plays made on the rush by Ridley Gregg. We've seen this a couple times where Gregg doesn't necessarily look to set up. He wants to try to challenge off the rush and puts the D, creates some confusion. And then, oh, not paying the price by Forrester to get in there. Gregg challenges her line and actually pokes it back. Does Gregg actually touch that back? Almost tapping it to Forrester, who finishes strong on your stick. And when you're finishing, all you care about. And now, first of all, he's going to, oh, the whiplash on that left knee will be a little interesting, as well as he's going to need a new skate blade in his left skate because his skate blade caught a lot of the post. But he looks like he's fine, no worse for wear. And
Forrester from Alliston, Ontario, a Philadelphia first round pick who played last year for Barry. An injury ravaged season for him. He only played 13 games.
Score a goal always feels better, though.
Yeah, he's got goals now in back-to-back games.
He was excellent as well last game. His best game of the tournament. Continue to build on that. Canada up two.
And five different power play goal scores for Canada now. And there's five power play goals. Loose puck goes to Juan. It bounced away to Kemmel. And Kemmel plays it back to center ice to Ratu. Out to Ratu. For Hirvonen, and that's steered away by Garand. Picked out now. And brought back by Kim. A long shot goes wide off the end boards. It goes. Garand trying to find the puck. Was stuck in the back of the net. They finally chop it off. Thompson gets it free. And Waugh back on it. Picked out now by Ratu. Ratu. Back for Hamasalmi. Hamasalmi bobbled the puck. Ratu's got it. Shoots the puck. The puck goes wide. Ratu, the second round pick of the Islanders in 2021. Kemmel works that free. Kemmel spins and shoots. He fired that wide. Here's the four back on it. Knocked away from him. Hirvonen centers it for Ratu. Back to Hirvonen. At the point is Hamasalmi. Hamasalmi had that pass broken up by Waugh. And Waugh head for DeFore. That was a clever play by Waugh. His stick was broken after he blocked that shot, so he played it gingerly. And then we'll grab a new one on the bench. Hamasalmi, the top defenseman of the under-18s earlier this year. As Hoffman brings it out. Chris pass ahead for Bedard. Bouncing puck in the offensive zone. Got away from Bedard, but it's held by Cormier. Hoffman centers it. Bounces back. It's heavy to shot. Pinballs around in front. Bedard tipped it wide. And that centering pass knocked down. And then brought out by Mata. Romato works it in, but the play's offside at the Canadian line. Tyson Forrester, the 20-year-old from Alliston, Ontario, has the power play goal, and Canada's got a 2-0 lead here in the first period on the final day of the preliminary round of the World Junior Hockey Championship. The Women's World Championship begins on August 25th. Canada will take on Finland. Coverage continues through September the 4th, and the Canadian team announced today. And Gina Kingsbury, the GM of the Canadian Women's National Team, will join James Duffy and the crew on set today. A five-time gold medalist. She's a terrific player.
That'll be great to watch as well as our August of hockey continues, yes, on TSN. One more look at this goal. And you see the two defensemen for Finland get caught. Then it's still the blue line. Generally, guys will take it wide and set up, but Ridley Gregg said, you know what, I'll take my chances attacking. And it's a nice job creating some chaos that Forrester cashes in from.
That pass knocked down by Johnson. Played back by Vincent. Now Kent Johnson back on the forecheck, wins that puck. Brings it back around. Zellweger jumps up, hacked away from him by Etu Liukas. Stankoven. Plays it back around for Seeley. And Seeley spins away neatly from Liukas. Back down to the finish zone. Played across to Kasper Puutio. He scored in all three games for the Finns. Johnson banks it high off the boards. The pass bounces down to Stankoven. Moves it to Forrester. And Stankoven chops that back down to the finish zone. Heads off on a change. Johnson knocks it down again, but it's squirted away. Brad Lambert comes through. He got wiped out there on the way through by Sabrango. In comes a Slapchuk. Shoots Maryland and looks back, but he's got it. And he's able to hang on.
A big collision in the neutral zone. Zabrango skating into it. Lambert's skating into it. And the puck's there. And you got to get the puck. Or you got to get the body. You cannot go over if you're Zabrango. And he certainly gets plenty of Brad Lambert. You got to keep that elbow tucked in. Can't have any sort of chicken wing flying out.
Nope.
No, that's okay. Just spun him around as he had to.
To him, Osami's a second-round pick of Carolina. Pops it back, Kemmel. Ratu shoots at the flex back in front. And Osami would be nice and comfortable with all those fins in Carolina, won't he?
Helsinki South.
Jordan Staal better start learning to finish.
Good players, too. Important players.
Sebastian Aho, chief among them.
Let's think on Carolina. He's an excellent player.
He is, too, yeah. Aho, a member of that 2016 gold medal team for the Finns that won in spectacular fashion. The golden goal in Helsinki scored by Kasperi Kapanen. They also won the golden goal in 2014 in Malmö. That was Rasmus Ristolainen. But back in 98, they won the golden goal.
Get it to overtime. Yeah. Chances.
Look at Leshock deflects right down to Garand. Makes a good stop there. That was Nicholas Hagman scored back in 98. In 2019, they didn't need overtime to win the gold medal in Vancouver. They won it with about 20 seconds to go in regulation against the United States in the gold medal game.
All intents and purposes, a gold medal.
Liukas plays it off the side of the goal. Racing back is Bedard. He collides there with Vaisanen. Walking across the top is Urmiel. In shoots, and that's knocked away by Garand. Kapanen back across to Putio. Putio works in and holds. It's a screen there from Liukas. And played back at the point for Yermo. Yoni Yermo back to Putio. Works it in, shoots it, got through Garand, save, rebound loose in front, that skipped away from Kapanen. Victory for the moment by Hoffman, move back in front, now gathered up by Cormier. Cormier off the glass, but it's gloved down by Putio. Again, the Finns hold possession in the offensive zone. Both teams changing. Cormier gets to it. End of a long shift for him. Flips it ahead to McTavish. Busting out with Bedard. McTavish goes rink wide and finds Bedard. Bedard in, shoots, goal! A lightning strike from Connor Bedard. And it's 3-0. What a shot!
Connor Bedard late in the shift. You think get it over the red line and dump it in. Bedard tops his circles and he absolutely wires this. Not a great angle. He's got himself getting closed off quickly by Yermo, but he gets it away so fast. Carolina's there, but the shooter's better than the goaltender. That is world class. That is 90 seconds into a shift. When you're tired, you can't do anything, including shoot. The fact that he has the energy, the gas left in the tank to go on that rush and to make that shot, incredible stuff by Connor Bedard.
51 goals in 62 games for Regina this year. Just the third 16-year-old ever to score 50 goals in the Western League.
That's just a shot that, you know, very few hockey players in the world can make at any age.
Before with that shot, that really is jaw-dropping. I mean, there are fans in the building still shaking their head about it.
Maybe one of them. It's just for a smaller guy, he just gets it away so fast, accurate, and hard. It's offside.
Joe Sakic had the best wrist shot I saw. I think Joe had, but this is...
So, 85 seconds into the shift. And he's got to take it wide. He's getting closed off. And again, look at the effort. Look at the... Everything in him he's putting into that shot. And the fall through we talked about. He really does emphasize pointing that total stick at the target.
And look at Del Mastro. Can you believe that? We watch it every day in practice. Yes, we can. Unreal. You know what? Maybe I just wasn't trying hard enough when I shot it. Because he has put in everything he has, and it looks like it, with great success.
This is Bedard's 17th game playing for Team Canada, his 20th goal.
He's draft eligible. He's just 17.
Just turned. But last
couple weeks.
Ben Johnson in, shoots. That's off the stick of Yemela. Up and out of play, and a 3-0 lead for Canada.
And you see the tape job. He releases the puck from the toe of his stick. Quick little drag into his feet, create a flex, and that's almost an abbreviated fall through as he's being chopped down on by Yermo, but man, it just, the replay almost doesn't do it justice how quickly that got on Marilainen. The shot, the endurance a minute and a half into the shift, and the finish, just beautiful by Connor Bedard.
He's from North Vancouver, Sakic's from Burnaby.
Something going on out in the West Coast. Talked about his stick. 70 flex.
70 flex.
Very whippy. Quite long relative to his height. So you have a little more chance to use that the shaft to flex and release.
So wouldn't you say two things that make it hard to handle a puck? The length of the stick and the flex.
Yes. Both make it more difficult. You're kind of trading off, you know, my shot versus my control, but he's obviously got it dialed in every aspect.
In comes Cooley with it. Shoots. It's off the stick of Puccio. Up and out of play. 1:19 to go here in the period. And some pushing and shoving after the whistle.
And if you're Finland, you're thinking, how are we down 3 in this period?
You know, the way they started, the first 5 minutes.
First 5-6 minutes.
Canada didn't have a shot.
Never Canada could get on their own end. And then one play down, Othman on a tip. And all of a sudden, Canada's on the board and feeling a little bit more comfortable in the game. The power play goal, pivotal to take advantage of that for Canada. Yeah. And then, a play that defended well, but sometimes great players make great plays, and that was just that for Connor Bedard. I was wondering if Antti Pettinen might be thinking, do we go to a different goaltender at this point?
They talked about it in the Czechia game. They got down 2-0 early against Czechia, and they talked about it on the bench, he said, afterwards, but they decided to stay with Levi Marilainen. We ended up getting the win in the shootout. He's great, by the way, at shootouts and penalty shots.
Don't want to let it get to that if Marilainen's in the net.
Ottawa with a third-round pick from Winnipeg for Dylan DeMello. Used that pick to take Levi Marilainen. Marilainen is trying to work that break. Gervinen centers it. Picked up by Hurley. Scores! With 56 seconds to go in the period, and the Finns are on the board.
Huge goal for Hellenius and Finland, as it was soft, broken coverage. Sealy in front of the net, Cooley's there as well. One of them has to recognize where the danger area is. And Hellenius sliding right there. And neither one gets out there in time. And the shot actually clips off a Canadian defender.
Right.
And deflects up and past Garand. But there's nobody in front of the net. And it's off Sealy's stick, I think, when it's all said and done. But if you're Cooley, you're the weak side forward, you drop down and take that guy. And if they pass it behind the defenseman, then you let him go. Or if you're Sealy, you got to get out and engage and trust the guy in front of the net. That's a little bit too wide open right in the slot, and that is huge. If Canada goes to the break 3-0, they feel great. Now 3-1, Finland right back in the game.
Lenny's been a project for LA, a second-round pick. Had just 3 goals this year in 48 games for JYP Viscala in the Finnish league.
A few kind of half coverages by just about everybody in the defensive zone there behind the net. Tavish, Thompson, Seeley, everyone not quite on top of their man.
Sabrango finds Greg, and racing back to knock that away was Rafkin. Zellweger pulled over his man, Jarventi. And now Lambert plays it back in. Roby Jarventi. And that knocked away. Hellenius knocked down Sabrango. Alan Sabrango tries to slide that back, and again, Finns maintain possession in the offensive zone. Knocked down by Niemela. Rolling puck for Tuukka Niemela. Bounce off his stick. Feeds it back down. Lambert a backhand shot. Grand makes the stop.
Finland will keep on pushing. The belief on the bench will be all the way back after scoring that goal. Knowing that they've been in this period, shots are 10-10. It's been quite even. And we'll just find a way to chip away. Keep playing the offensive zone. Canada's having trouble with Finnish cycle plays and defensive attacks, or attacks from the defenseman in the offensive zone.
Here's Del Mastro with it. Up ahead for Johnson. Johnson, rink wide for McTavish, jumping in with Forrester. McTavish works it in, rolling puck knocked down by Pudio. And the play called.
Kent Johnson ran in the net, knocked it off.
That's off. So
faceoff would go outside if it's with
0.3 seconds left in the period.
Won't really matter. Kent Johnson drive the far post. Didn't do a great job of trying to stop. Just sort of skated into it. So that faceoff should. Now they're going to be. If they put more time back on the clock, this faceoff should actually be outside the blue line. 0.3 is not enough time to make it happen, I don't think.
Scramble drop, and so Canada, on the strength of goals by Hoffman, Forrester, and Bedard, we're going to dress him with a 3-1 lead. Hornia strikes for the Finns. You're watching the final day of the preliminary round of the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championship Summer Edition. Our first intermission coming up with James Duffy, Bob McKenzie, Cheryl Pounder, and Jeff O'Neill. That's all ahead from Edmonton.
Here's your first intermission on TSN. Hoffman, Forrester, and Connor Bedard's third goal of the tournament, seventh World Junior goal, and he's with our Tessa Bonhomme.
Connor, it took a couple minutes for the team to find their footing there, but as far as what the coach was asking in that first period of play, did the team execute?
Yeah, I thought after, you know, I think they kind of took it to us in those first, you know, 2-3 minutes, and then obviously it was a big goal by Otter to kind of get us going and, you know, obviously get a power play, and, you know, I thought we had a good period overall.
Speaking of big goals, did you see that opening on that side, short side?
I don't know. I mean, I'm just on that side. I like to shoot there sometimes, and, you know, I just try to shoot as hard as I can, and, you know, luckily it went in.
As far as the team building off of that play, you got your power play goal under your belt. Special teams are very important in this play. Is there anything you guys want to clean up in your own end?
I think we were getting hemmed in there a little bit, and, you know, I think there was a few, even on my goal there, we were in our end for I don't know how long, but I think if we can, you know, get it out our first opportunity and, you know, not let them get that possession, then I think we'll be pretty good.
Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
James Duffy back with Cheryl Pounder, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie. You notice an MJ, when he closes his eyes. I noticed that on the first goal in the Latvia game when he has that shot. Doesn't matter, finds the perfect spot, it seems, almost every time. And he'd gone almost two full games without scoring. Remember, he scored early in the second game of the tournament, but still a bunch of chances and posts in there. He feels inevitable that a goal is always coming.
Well, he's good for a goal game. In a Team Canada sweater at any level, under 17, under 18, World Junior Tournament, he is good for a goal a game. It's usually the first goal of the game, but nevertheless, number three in this case will work. But, you know, James, there's a familiar pattern emerging here in this hockey game, and that is Team Canada is having a real difficult time getting out of their own end. The Finns are winning the battles. The Finns are taking pucks. Canada's turning the puck over all over the place. This was just right before. This is McTavish's line. They're stuck in the zone, and they can't get hold of the puck, and they're playing all defense. And you're thinking, my boy, you're going to have a real tough time if Connor Bedard's spending all that time in his own end. And then McTavish picks up the do-do-do-do-do. Okay, I'm going to make a ridiculous pass. That was a ridiculous catch in terms of receiving that pass and knocking it out of the air. And I've been watching hockey for a long time, professionally since, what, 1982? I've never seen anybody in junior hockey shoot a puck the way this kid shoots a puck, the way it comes off his stick and the way he releases it. I didn't see Mike Bossy play junior hockey, but I've got to think we must be seeing the same thing all over again.
You're right. They had those issues that you mentioned, but and that was right from the start, the first few minutes. What turned it around?
Well, Connor Bedard said it was 2 or 3 minutes. They weren't very good. It was actually 8, what I have on my sheet. 8 minutes, they weren't very good. And coaches will always tell you the only way out of that is through simplicity, and that's what Hoffman does on this play. There's nothing fancy here. This is not the Michigan goal. This is simple fundamentals of hockey. Get in on the forecheck, get the puck. You have support from Bedard there, and once you're done that job, you just don't sit and wait for the puck in the corner. You get out to the front of the net, and Zellweger does a fantastic job. That's a coach's dream right there, to see that response. They weren't very good, and just keep it simple to get back into the hockey game, and they started rolling after that.
Well, and I love Zellweger's position there. He shrunk the zone. He knew exactly where the play was. He just turned around, and those first few strides to the middle of the ice to be able to get the shot on net and through, that's something that he does very well.
O-Dog has his my guy list. He claims different guys all the time. He has half the roster, the apple of Jeff's eyes, his cat's meow. I say that because you love cats. But I think that Ridly Greig, Cheryl has claimed, because she's been talking about him
before
the tournament even started.
Stepping on your toes.
How critical was that line in the first?
Oh, they were so effective. We talked about them having to be heavy on the wall. You knew that they were going to have to play some shutdown minutes and control neutral ice, but in the offensive zone, they did wonders. I mean, led by DeFore as well, turnover after turnover, and recognizing everyone's on one side of the ice, and Cormier with beautiful timing here. He actually has 2 assists in the period. And then, of course, recognizing the coverage is all down low, working the puck high. You see the triangle right there? That's the ability to get pucks to one another. But this is where my guy shines as he comes through the middle of the ice. You know, he's got that persistence about him, the drive, the competitive nature. Says, I'm taking it. I'm going to attack. And Tyson Forster cleans up the garbage. So, yep, Ridly Greig doing it all here. My guy.
You okay with that, O?
Sorry, O.
I am. I'm fine with it.
That was a critical goal for Finland, because this was one more Canadian goal away from being over.
It can't happen in the last minute of a hockey game. I've heard overheard conversations with coaches, the fourth line players. Do not take stupid penalties and do not get scored on, especially with a minute left in the hockey game. And you're looking at Canada right now. There's got to be hard plays right here off the boards. Don't get out battled. And for one thing, you cannot leave the core of the ice open. And for that to happen, everyone talks about anybody involved in hockey. First minutes of period, James, and last minutes of period are so important. And they gave up a goal there. That's critical.
See if the Finns can build on that when the second starts in just a few minutes' time. But first, Gina Kingsbury will join us, the director of hockey operations for Canada's women's team. The national women's team has been named for the upcoming World Championships. Who's on? Who's off? Gina joins us next. Represent Canada for the tournament. Some new players on the team that we've highlighted. Some new old players in terms of Megan Mickelson back on there, Victoria Bach, Jesse Eldridge, Sarah Potomac, and Kristen O'Neill, the newcomers to this team. And joining us now, Hockey Canada's Director of Hockey Operations for the women's program, and that's Gina Kingsbury. We tried to organize some lines and defense pairings for you. I won't hold you to that. But the question is, how do you like your team's chances, looking at that roster, to win a third straight gold medal after the Worlds last year and the Olympics?
I love our chances. I think it's going to be challenging. There's no doubt about it. There's definitely, it's a new lineup. We're going to have to figure out how to speed up the new players into the concepts that we've taught all year long last year. But I really love the dynamics of this lineup, and we're really looking forward to competing.
It's really a two-pronged story in that roster, who's there and who's not there. We'll start with who's there, and one of the stories is Megan Mickelson, who is at 37 years old, a three-time Olympian, going to be appearing in her 8th Worlds after not making the Olympic team, getting back. What did she do to get back on this team?
She came extremely prepared to selection camp that we just finished here yesterday, and she just brings a ton of stability at the blue line. So we needed some stability, and she brought what she needed to camp, and we're really happy with her.
Of equal significance is a trio of really key players who are going to be missing from this team. Claire Thompson's off to medical school, taking a break. Melody Daou's taking a break for family reasons. Natalie Spooner expecting a child. We congratulate Natalie. These are three big holes. How do you fill their contributions?
We do it collectively. I don't think you replace those three players. They're very important to our roster. I think we do it collectively as a group. And I think with the pieces that we put together, we'll be in a good position to defend our gold medal.
The national women's team issued a statement calling for equal rights and a safe environment for all hockey participants in response to the crisis that Hockey Canada is embroiled in right now and the crisis in confidence among Canadians. Do you believe there's enough diversity as far as race, gender, sexual orientation in the key senior decision-making positions in Canadian hockey?
I think we're making the right steps moving forward. I think with Andrea Skinner being our lead on the board, I think that's a really important step. And I think there's room for growth still, and I hope Hockey Canada will continue to push the envelope in that department.
They have made a list in response to this of things that they want to change. Is there something in there that you see as the number one priority?
I think continuing to push for diversity, I think, is important, from all aspects, but definitely in a decision-making platform, I think, is an important piece.
The Canada-U.S. rivalry is going to continue. Look, it's been one of the greatest rivalries in sports we've seen for the last 20 years. Have you had a good look at the American roster for the Worlds and how Canada shapes up against them?
It's going to be a great, great matchup. As usual, they put together a great roster, and we're looking forward to competing against them for this cycle here in the next 4 years. For sure.
And you head over to Denmark shortly?
Yes, our team leaves tomorrow, and I join them on Friday, and we're really looking forward to what's to come.
Well, we can't wait to watch. Thank you so much for taking
a little
bit of time to join us today. That is Gia Kingsbury, who is the director of hockey operations for the women's national teams. Canada set to defend their world championship title in Denmark in just a few days. The Canadians here up 3-1 over Finland as we head towards the second period at the World Juniors on TSN. Great for Canada to open up the game. Othman second, Forster second, and Connor Bedard his third. And remember, if you're just joining us for the first time this tournament, Bedard had that 4-goal game back in December. Those stats count for that game. So we now have 7 World Junior goals. Gord Miller, Mike Johnson, and the second.
James, we mentioned the fact that Connor Bedard was the third 16-year-old to score 50 goals in the Western Hockey League. Dan Lucas and Glenn Goodall were the others. They had both turned 17 that year when they scored their 50th. Bedard's the only player in the history of that league to score 50 at the age of 16.
So he's special is what you're trying to say.
Yes.
And he shows that. And this was not a great first period for Canada. In their own end, they made some mistakes. They played a little bit too much defense. But sometimes, no matter how good of a system you play against someone, great players can make great plays. And for Finland, who did a lot of things right, it was a great individual left by Ridley Gregg on a power play, breaking down the defense, and Tyson Forster is able to cash it in. Not much you can do about that. And then this one, Finland actually had the puck in the offensive zone for over a minute, but sometimes players just make great individual plays, and that shot is still has the crowd buzzing. Something uniquely special about the way Connor Bedard could shoot the puck. And if you're Canada, you're loving 3-1, but you know you need to play a little bit better, because that wasn't a perfect period by any stretch. It was really quite even. In fact, 5-on-5, it probably favored Finland.
Do you think the Bedards have like a dented dryer or garage door or
something? Although with the accuracy, I'm sure he could just put like a little piece of plexiglass out there and hit it anytime he wanted to. But hearing Connor talk to Tessa in the intermission, he said it. I'm trying to shoot the puck as hard as he can. And I think it seems obvious. But it's not.
When you saw the replay, the slow-mo of him flexing that stick, I mean, it's astonishing.
But having played in the NHL, like you're always trying to shoot it hard, but you're not really shooting it as hard as you physically can, because there's other stuff going on, trying to get it off, trying to find the location, worrying about what's happening around you. But it seems as though he really does throw everything he possibly can into his shot.
Zellweger tees it up and shoots. Good stuff by Maryland. Rebound score! Busting in is Ridley Gregg. And it's 4-1.
I think Ridley Gregg likes this kind of game. Give me a matchup, let me sink my teeth into it, and be effective. So he's out there again, Ratu again. And watch him spin off. Ratu gets caught staring at the puck. And Ridley Gregg's able to beat him to the front of the net. Really good one-timer by Zellweger. So that puck's way in front of him. Not an easy shot to make. Good tip by Oahu pick up another point as all he does is get points. And Ridley Gregg, that you make good players defend. Ratu doesn't want to play in his own end. And Gregg takes advantage, moving his feet, staying loose, and jumping on the rebound of what was a really good first save by Marilainen.
Now the puck picked up below the goal line by Johnson. So Ridley Gregg's got his third of the tournament. Scored 26 goals in 39 games this year for Brandon in the Western League.
Ottawa, good things are happening in Ottawa right now.
Gregg was a first round pick. The pick they got for Jean-Gabriel Pageau, one of the picks they got from the Islanders for Jean-Gabriel Pageau.
He might be a very Pageau-like player.
Johnson from a sharp angle, stop made by Marilainen.
Play kind of down the lineup a little bit, but still produce offense.
And if you've been watching Team USA's games in the tournament, Tyler Cleven, the defenseman for Team USA, has been rattling the glass and boards every game with thundering hits. Jason Backer's Cormier, icing called against the Finns.
Ridley Gregg starts the play for the goal on the faceoff. So he's got to dig in, scramble this drop. Doesn't really win it, but kind of controls it with escape by stepping on it. Eventually gets support from Dufour. And then watch Ratu and Gregg to the top of your screen. Ratu thinks he's going to seal off Gregg's stick with kind of trying to pin it under his body. And Gregg's not long to let that happen. And pounces on the loose puck. Nose for the net.
Yeah. Native of Lethbridge, Alberta. Stats mentioned scouting for Philadelphia. Played for four teams in the NHL. Flyer GM Chuck Fletcher jokes that they do take the Mark Gregg scouting reports of the Canada games with a grain of salt. They seem tilted in one particular direction.
A lot of mentions of the 17 for Canada.
Oh, Pelennius, a backhand shot that was blocked by Sabrango, and Bedard plays it back out. Between periods, pro scouts that are here, NHL scouts, just astonished by the Bedard goal.
As they should be. It was something special.
Icing waved off as Sabrango goes back. He gets crunched into the inboards by Pelennius. Wide around, here's Niemela with it. Tuppy Niemela. Shoots with that high and wide. Pelennius back on it. Into the corner for Lambert. Plays that back and was kept alive by Rafkin. Now picked off and moved up by Hoffman, who opened the scoring for Canada. Crisp pass ahead for Bedard. Bumps there with Rafkin. And at the line, kept alive by Thompson. Down to Bedard. Bedard bites off Rafkin, stays on it. Bedard still with it. Bedard throws that back in the corner for Waugh. Joshua Waugh with a shot. And Marilainen makes the stop with Gregg parked right at the side of the finish goal. And Ridley Gregg with Brandon. We mentioned the 28th overall pick by the Ottawa Senators in the 2020 draft. And that pipeline of prospects that is flowing in Ottawa right now.
Still a year or two away maybe before he arrives, but it won't be long.
Jake Sanderson should be there promptly. Walking in now, Dufour with a shot. And Marilainen, the save,
behind him,
loose.
Behind him,
touching his pads. They dig away at it, and finally he freezes it. You can hear the players yelling, it's loose.
Nobody from Finland knew it was behind Marilainen, and he's thinking there, he's waiting for a whistle, he's got it covered. But the referee, not blowing it down. Another play off a face-off, Dufour walks around and kind of dribbles between his feet. Oh, it's right there. Joshua Waugh would have dug in and maybe looked for it. He thought it was going to be a whistle, or Gregg as well. And then finally, they go hacking after it's been covered. It's rare. Goaltenders have such a great feel. They almost always know where that puck is in their gear. Even though so much gear, I don't know how they feel it.
The puck weighs 6 ounces.
And all that pad, but they always seem to know when it's dribbling through. Seems like Gregg's having a good time on the faceoff. Great offense.
Zero for Järventie. Banks that back down. You're obviously another Ottawa prospect.
This is Marilainen in net for Finland.
Yeah. Had an up and down year for Kingston in the Ontario League at Marowina. Shane Wright's teammate with the front net. Gaucher trying to knock that down, and it's brought up by Madden. A stop check came back on him. O'Rourke back around to Cormier, lifts it ahead for Gaucher. That was knocked down by Biro. That was a breakaway for Canada's Nathan Gaucher. Now the lead pass for Hirvonen. Donnie Hirvonen tried to flip that back ahead. Kick to Kelly Vaisanen. Vaisanen got spun around. And Will Cooley up ahead for a stop check. He's taken down. And the puck rolls down to Marowina. Yermo up for Liukas. That was stolen by Johnson. And Gaucher couldn't reach it. Here's Zellweger. Up to Gaucher, who chips it back down to the finish zone as Canada starts to change, but the puck was played with a high stick and play is called.
And the early goal by Canada undoes all the positivity that Finland would have felt by their late goal. And the idea that they're closing the gap and getting back into a game, and now it's stretched out to 3 once again. Finland will have to try to keep pushing and creating the offense as Canada's gotten off to the better start in period two.
That long shot by Sabrango goes wide. So when you talk about a player being 16 when he scores 50, it's obviously in your 16-year-old year. This is still Connor Bedard's 16-year-old year at the World Junior, even though he turned 17 a couple weeks ago.
It's all a little skewed with the 8 months later, but right. Yes.
Vancouver for Zellweger, back for Sabrango, a shot. Carolina the stop there, and the rebound tipped away. That was deflected in front. Now Zellweger back with it. Knocked away from Forster. And lead pass by Niemela. Finds Lambert. Lambert throws that hook wide for Niemela. Vancouver, a crisp pass there for Forster. And he finds Johnson moving in, shoots, and Carolina makes a point-blank save on Kent Johnson. Now the pass misfires for Lambert. Back goes Thompson. A nice and called against the Finns, who were almost burned there.
More chances. Kent Johnson, late in the shift, knows he's going to get caught. You're wondering, why is he shooting from so far away? Because he knows a couple more strides, and he's very likely to be tracked down by Puutio. So he steps on it quickly, trying to get under the pads. Man, the line makes a nice save. But Zellweger and Sabrango, again, have had a really good game. Jumping down, turns it over, wins it back. He's got a couple assists on the night already, does Zellweger. He has been really good for Canada in this tournament.
Now Greg centers it. Before reaching for it, the puck loose in the pads again of Marowina, but this time he grabs it. Waugh was in there digging. Puutio gets in his face.
Waugh, Dufour. Joking that really Greg's going to have to polish up on some of his French, because that's the sentiment between two French-speaking, primarily French-speaking wingers. Take advantage of their natural tongue. And I think Waugh's been very comfortable since he's been paired with Dufour.
Yeah, he started the tournament on the line with Bedard and McTavish. Moves ahead. In comes Hirvonen. Hirvonen drops it off to Ratu, winds in. Ratu plays that back, and Tommy is shot through the traffic. Durant makes the stop. Picked up by Dufour. In comes Greg with it. And Hirvonen chips it back down to the Canadian line. Del Mastro swings back. Oh, turnover. Ratu chipped that wide. Now settled down by Waugh.
I don't think Del Mastro anticipated Ratu jumping down on him.
4-1 Canada leads. You're watching the final day of the opening round of the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championship and the High Level Bridge in Edmonton. Oh, do we have a day for you on Wednesday? It starts at noon Eastern, 10 o'clock local time. 4 quarterfinals in one day, all in a row in this building.
It's a quick 12-hour set for us. And our crew will be grinding early and often as we get down to the semifinals. Here's Del Mastro When someone chases you behind, you don't ever expect another forward to jump on you right in front. But Ratu catches Del Mastro by surprise. He's like, well, wait a second. And Moran's got to be aware. And we won't actually know the full quarterfinal matchups until after our final game today.
Sweden plays Germany in the nightcap tonight.
The winner gets second place in that group.
Switzerland, a narrow 3-2 win over Austria in the first game today. It was a 2-2 tie in the third period. Austria called for a five-minute major and game misconduct, the fifth game misconduct we've seen so far in the tournament. And on the ensuing five-minute power play, the Swiss scored to punch their ticket to the quarters.
Nail biter. Austria thought they'd pull a Latvian-like Uzbek into the quarters. That'll be it for them. Slovakia and Austria will be not advancing.
No relegation in this year's tournament.
Right.
5 years ago, the Finns were in the relegation against Latvia. They came unraveled in the World Junior in Edmonton and Montreal. And you're after winning it at home ice. Fired their coach on New Year's Eve. Long shooting. Garand makes the stop. And Bedard gathers it back up. Here comes Connor Bedard again with McTavish and Cooley on the right wing this time. Way back to center ice. And a penalty coming now.
Bedard going to get a hold after all that.
Holding the stick on Bedard.
Dragged it out of Mata's hands.
And so the Finns with that lethal power play that's 8 for 13 so far will get the man advantage.
Team Canada, number 16, minor penalty, holding the stick.
Connor Bedard, who has been on the receiving end of a lot of extra attention from all opponents. So he's trying to get the puck up the ice. Chips it in deep. Little shove there, no problem that. Little shove. It's almost hard to see. That. I mean, he wasn't holding the stick very firmly, but he took it right out of his hand, so I guess when you're skating around with his stick in your hand, it's tough to say you didn't grab it.
Matsa and Hirvonen lead the way for the Finns with two power play goals each. With five against Slovakia.
That's what we talked about. Coming into this game, 62% on the power play for Finland.
And the Finns right away send it right back down. Canada will have one power play goal and eight opposition opportunities so far. Niemela. Tumpy Niemela. Swings that back for Ratu. Up for Hirvonen. Chips that back in. Ronnie Hirvonen. Lays it back in the corner. Gauthier gets to it. Fed back at the point. Here's Niemela. In. Shoots for Trevick and Grant. Snakes out the left hand and makes the glove save.
Grabbed through traffic, was able to see it enough to snare it. Grand, not the biggest guy, got to work around his defenders. Oh yeah, he's working around Ridley Gregg and Hirvonen in front as well. Up and down, I mean, you got to work. You got to work to be a goaltender to spot pucks through all of those bodies, your own teams included. As everyone's trying to get in your line of sight.
Face off won by McTavish. And McTavish trying to dig it free, but it goes back to the point to Niemela. Across to Putio. Putio breaks that back in the corner. Simon Tybel is trying to get free. And now Chop free to chance, shorthanded with DeFore. In comes William DeFore, shorthanded, stopped by Marilainen. And DeFore was a lethal goal scorer in the Quebec League this year, led that league with 56 goals in 66 games. As Ratu works in. Now the centering pass knocked down by Kemmel. Goes off the end of that discarded stick and out.
Dirty butt end for Finland. Their own team stick in the way.
Joakim Kemmel, 17th overall to Nashville in the 2022 draft.
Well, you are allowed to shoot that out of the way if you want. There you go.
Finally do some cleanup down there. Played back by Jarventi. Shoots and the stuff. Jarventi got it away. The save made by Garand. Here's Jarventi again. Looking for a stick in front. Picked up now by Kemmel. Kemmel. And Asami shoots. Garand to save. Cena gets to the rebound and rings it around and couldn't get it out.
Keep.
Final seconds of the power play. Now McTavish knocks it down as Bedard's back on the ice. Garvey a shot that's blocked. Two shots from the Finns in that power play. Tired penalty kills on the ice for Canada. Long shot knocked down by Seely. And Seely will buy some time. The Finns are making changes. Bedard remains out there along with Cooley. Seely. Game center ice and banks out ahead. Knocked down by Puteo. Blue pass knocked down by Thompson. Away comes Jack Thompson. Drops for Bedard. In shoot! And the save made by Marijuana. A late bump there by Thompson draws some attention.
Lots going on that Finnish power play. First off, the stick line. What are the chances? Right off the butt out of the stick for the zone clearance. That's a good one for Cannon. Here's why the stick's on the ground. And I wonder if DeFour recognized that the Emma had dropped the stick, because sometimes you think he's chasing you and you have to make a quick move, but he elected to shoot, not quite able to find it. And there's that wrister. That time, Marilainen gets the best of Connor Bedard. It's at that point where anytime he gets a good look, you expect him to almost score.
Forrester tees it up and shoots. And that was blocked by Kapanen. Liukas chops that up, but the pass is knocked down by O'Rourke. Played back in. Stankoven looking for it. And Logan Stankoven gets to it for Canada. Drops it back for Seely. Seely keeps it alive down to Johnson. Johnson works out of the corner. Spins and shoots. That was blocked. Loose puck goes to Forrester. Centers it. Stankoven spins it back to Johnson with a shot. That's blocked. Rebound. Marilainen to save up high. Took that right off the mask. And now Cormier holds the line again. Great job to walk the blue line.
Oh, wow.
Back he goes to Johnson. Kent Johnson spins it back for O'Rourke. Down to the goal mouth to Forrester. Chops it back, and once again, it's kept alive by Johnson. Kent Johnson holds. Crisscrossing O'Rourke, drops it back to Cormier. Back to Johnson, tees up and shoots, and a pass saved by Marilainen. These spins are exhausted now. O'Rourke back to Forrester. Forrester spins that back to O'Rourke. Down to Stankoven. Walks in. Shoots. Puck triples out of that rebound. And Johnson turned away by Marilainen. Lots of good chances for Canada. William DeFour killing a penalty. Gets a short-handed breakaway. Stopped by Levi Marilainen. It remains a 4-1 lead for Canada against Finland. It's the epic prequel to the groundbreaking Game of Thrones, House of the Dragon, an HBO original series streams Sunday, August 21st, and you can only watch it on Crave.
Canada has really tilted the ice to start the second period, but an awful lot in the offensive zone, and Kent Johnson had an excellent shift. Probably should have been rewarded with a goal here, because all the work, he gets Marilainen down, he gets the loose puck on his backhand, and he heels it into the pad when he should have just shoveled it upstairs. Chip it upstairs, it's wide open. He just doesn't quite get it after a long sequence in the offensive zone.
Denoyer up for the faceoff. Elliot Denoyer has seen winter ice time here in the game so far. Thanks for Halifax and the Quebec Major Junior League. Halifax and Moncton, co-hosts of the upcoming 2023 World Junior Championship.
Samuel Hellenius runs over everybody he bumps into. Must always end up on the ice. He is large.
Amos Salmi for Lambert. Brad Lambert, the Winnipeg Jets' first round pick. Selected 30th overall in the most recent NHL draft. Mayan by reaching for it, taken away by Denoyer. 8.5 to go here in the second period. Canada 4-1 lead. Finns got off to a great start in the game. Canada reeled off three straight to grab the advantage. Zellweger shoots. Pad save Marilainen. Rebound loose in front. Scooped up by Lambert. And Lambert across to Hellenius. Back for Lambert. Lambert was a highly touted prospect for the draft last year. His stock fell somewhat this year. Didn't have a big productive year in the Finnish league.
He was thought to be a top 10 guy heading into this year.
He was actually moved in mid-season to Pelicans Lahti.
That'd be tough. I mean, you're playing pro hockey, so it can happen, but you're a teenager getting traded and chopped around, and
Well, it's your draft year. There's all the pressure that goes with it. Long shot taken by Simon Teibel. Kicked away in a race for it. Now he comes to four again. He gets a stab to four. In! Turn away again by Marilyn. Another chance. That's hacked wide by Greg. Here's Greg back on it. Back of the line, Sabrango. Fonzie goes ceiling with a shot that's kicked out by Marilyn. Ridley Greg back on it. Greg stays with it, feeds it back in front for Dufour, spins and shoots, that's blocked. But another double away, that's kicked wide by Wall. Greg with a shot. Marilyn has knocked the net off. And play is called here, 6:55 to go in the period.
What a game this line is having. Greg, Roy, Dufour just buzzing in the offensive zone. And finally, Marilyn is banging around, says, you know what? We could use the net coming off. So he gets heavy into that one. And crazy carom off the boards as Dufour is almost in again. I wonder if anyone, Greg was coming in behind him, if he could have maybe slid a drop pass back while drawing in the check. That's two near breaks for William Dufour.
Shots are 16-4 Canada in the second period.
Canada's been so much better in the second period because they're playing in the offensive zone. Been a bit better on their own end, but they've been way better up the ice.
Thompson plays that to McTavish. Down to Cooley. This is McTavish, Cooley, and Gauthier in the forward line for Canada. Here's Cooley back with it. Will Cooley. Drops that back. Centering pass just missed McTavish. Now Thompson back with it. In for McTavish. And McTavish plays it down to Cooley. Back for Thompson. Shoots. That got knocked away. And Gauthier with a chance. It goes off a stick. Ramps up and out of play.
And if you're wondering what's going on with these strange lines, Greg, who they want to play against Ratu, had just finished a long shift in the offensive zone. We're tired. Out comes Ratu. So they go two wingers from the fourth line and then Mason McTavish as the responsible center to pair between them. Still up 4-1, but respecting the line matchups and rotations that Dave Cameron has been after all game long, doing his best to take the number one line of Finland out of the game.
Here's Johnson with it. Back to Zellweger, shoots, it ramps off a stick again, up and out of play with 6:05 to go.
That's almost surprising that Zellweger had a shot block. He is exceptional at walking the line laterally, able to shoot it off his back foot and still get plenty on it. I've been impressed with his game.
Johnson. For O'Rourke, that deflects wide. Zellweger shoots, and that's gloved by Marilainen. 5:52 to go here in the second period. It has been the Connor Bedard show for Canada. Night after night, spectacular goals, including another one here today in a 4-1 lead for Canada. So Team Canada looking to run its record of 4-0 in the opening round, secure first place in its group into the quarterfinals. On Wednesday, Sweden will play Germany today. The United States has clinched first place in that group after the win over Sweden last night.
The winner of this game gets Switzerland, who came last. Latvia came third, and then Sweden and U.S. first. Is that right? So yeah, I might bang that around a little bit, but the winner of this game gets Switzerland.
Yeah. Chip back down the Canadian zone. And Garan plays it around. Dylan Garan had a great year for Kamloops in the Western League last year. He got to the Western Conference Final before losing to Seattle. Back across his bureau. Shoots. Pinballs around in front. Picked up by Denoyer. And a lead pass for McTavish. Babchuk in there. The lines are all over the place here now. As back goes Cormier for it. He got spun around. O'Rourke got tied up in the corner. There's Kapanen stepped into him and then threw down O'Rourke. And the referee says play on. Denoyer moves in. In comes McTavish. Goes behind his back. Loose puck in front. Kicked up by Marilainen. Zellweger holds the line again. Drops it back, but it's picked off and brought out by Vaisanen. Kelly Weiss, another Ranger pick. Got it back around the stop shot. Loose in the corner. Zellweger got it back up. Here's Sabrango. The matchups have kind of gone away here. It began with Zellweger and Sabrango up against the top line for Finland, but with the score now 4-1, it's become less of an issue in terms of matching as Niemela moves around. And a penalty coming. It's going to be interference. That's going to go on Ruben Rafkin. And Canada gets a power play here with 4:27 to go in the second.
So bad.
Team Finland, number three, 2-minute liner. Interference.
It is interference. What he's upset is that Stankoven, he feels, went down pretty easily on the bump. So there's no reason for Rafkin to be skating towards the corner in that situation other than to throw Stankoven off the pursuit. So there's interference. So that was the accidental elbow. That really was accidental. When the stick goes towards the board, you have to leave your backhand up in the air. Kapanen eats O'Rourke's elbow and then grabs his jersey, and Christopher Holmes just says, play on. I'll give you both a penalty or nobody a penalty. Here's a chance to really stretch it out.
Five different power play goal scorers for Canada in the tournament. Kent Johnson.
Kind of trying to find Bedard at some point.
Zellweger shoots. Carolina save. Rebound back in front to McTavish. Stankoven back with it. Klaus, it goes to Johnson. Works that back to Zellweger. Feeds it across to Stankoven. Johnson holds. Feeds it back in front. Bouncing puck up the goal post. And Marilainen somehow keeps that out. McTavish and Bedard both looking back as the puck was right on the line.
Stankoven, a good job finding a seam to Johnson. And Johnson looking to go back against the grain for a stick. McTavish or Bedard, they both wanted, they're both presenting their sticks. Bedard gets the first piece, caroms around, hits the post. And it's just so rare that McTavish isn't able to find it off his skate, off the post. And then, oh, he jams it back in as well.
Picked out by Bedard. Connor Bedard. Back for Johnson. Kent Johnson slithers in. Feeds it down to McTavish. At the point is Zellweger. The McTavish shoots. And Mason McTavish has his seventh of the tournament. And Canada's got a 5-1 lead. And that's another new power play goal scorer for Canada.
Just a shooting clinic being put on by these top players for Canada. Mason McTavish goes upstairs. All starts with Connor Bedard winning a puck battle race off a scrum draw, keeping it alive, and then a rotation. McTavish slides into Johnson's spot. Says, you know what? I think I want a one-timer. Zellweger drag him to the middle, create a bit of a softer angle so it's not so downhill, a little more square. And McTavish gets the elevation he's looking for. Makes no mistake. Mason McTavish has every shot in the book. Like, when it comes to putting pucks past goaltenders, he can do it all.
Scored his first NHL game with Anaheim last year. Scored twice in his first 9 before being sent back. Had a hat trick in his first game back with Peterborough. Later got traded to Hamilton. Scored 20 goals in 29 games for them. And went all the way to the Memorial Cup final. Oh, yeah, playing the Olympics, too.
Slip that in your February as well.
Now Ratu tries to feed it back across. Correa the save in tight. And another. Back goes to Putio. Putio works in. Brings it back around. And don't forget Dylan Garand holding Canada in the early going in this game. Putio winds and shoots. Garand the save. Rebound loose in front. Rolled away from Ratu. Now a centering pass. Herman and shoots. Garand another save.
Take another breakaway.
Dufour comes busting in once again on Yermo. And Dufour tried to pull a stick out of there. Yermo had it. Away comes Yermo. Shoots off the skate of Cormier wide. Got it up by Sabrango. NYA. Up for Wong. Ring wide to Cormier, who bats that back down to the finish zone. Emil Viro moves it back out. Viro in on Cormier. Viro gets a step, sends it back in front. That's cluttered wide. Viro back with it. And Osami back in for Viro. He's got Gauthier all over it. Now Del Mastro shields off Yarvinti. And Osami to Viro. This wide pass, and fending on that was Mata. Mata stepped hard into Cormier in the corner. And Cormier lost the handle for a moment. Yarvinti centers it, knocked down by Del Mastro. And finally moved out by Canada. Emil Selmick to Viro. Jumping in is Weissener. Valley Weissener. A skilled in the corner by Del Mastro. Weissener back in for Rafkin. Forster got Cruncher along the board.
But he made the play, didn't he? Took the hit, popped it back, allowing for a controlled exit here, and ideally not a turnover by Kent Johnson, because he needs two defensemen to get off the ice.
Rafkin winds in, shoots, that's blocked by Del Mastro. Another centery pass that got away from Liukas. Picked out now by Johnson. He got spun around at center ice, and again, Canada can't get this defense pair off. Del Mastro to Cormier. Up ahead along with a discarded stick for Stankoven to Johnson. In comes Kent Johnson as time winds down. Thompson. Back around for Johnson. Tries to center it. And Thompson bats out ahead to Stankoven. Move back down the Canadian zone. Zellbrin goes back. And icing's called against the Finns. So Dylan Garand has stood tall here for Canada so far in this tournament. We say Dylan Garand. And we want to get the names right. There's his dad, Lauren. He says Garand. So he asked him, well, could you guys decide which one's which? He said, well, he's the famous one. We'll go with Garand. By the way, this coming Saturday is Lauren Garand's birthday. When he saw the World Junior schedule come out and realized his birthday is on the day of the gold medal game.
Quite a present for Mr. Garand. Or however they want to say it.
Darren Garand. So now here's the problem. Now I'll double clutch every time. The kid says Garand, that's what we say.
Parents don't want to be saying how we say our names anymore. Garand it is.
You played with one of the Mihalik brothers, right?
I played with Zvanek.
It was Milan as well. They couldn't decide. One said Mihalik, one said Mihalik.
Brothers.
Chaos ensued. Canada adds two more here in the second period. Goals by Greg and McTavish. It's a 5-1 lead for Canada. It's the final day of the opening round of the 2022 World Junior Hockey Championships. Our second edition for James Duffy, Bob McKenzie, Cheryl Pounder, and Jeff O'Neill is coming up.
Back for a second intermission here on TSN. Oh, the t-shirt craze has spread. Look, the three key members of the panel all have diehard fans at the game.
Swear, I'm leaving this panel.
There they are.
Where's the guy with my shirt? He was just up here.
Three key members of the panel. What are you saying? Oh?
Where's the guy with my shirt? We took a picture with them, the whole family.
I don't recall that, and if it's not on camera, it didn't happen. Love those fans. Thank you for your support. You okay? He was visibly upset the other day when there wasn't a t-shirt of him when they showed me and Bob, so this might push him over the edge. The power play for Canada was 4-for-8 coming into this game. That's hardly a struggle at 50%, but they made some adjustments, and how have they paid off in a 2-for-2 performance today?
Well, the power play's been absolutely dynamite, obviously, 2-for-2 today. One of the interesting adjustments they made was taking the great shooter Connor Bedard out of the shooting position, off of the flank, and putting him into the middle. And what happens when you put him in the bumper spot is he draws that much more attention. So everything was focused on making sure that Bedard wasn't going to get that puck. And there's Mason McTavish wide open on the side, boom, and away you go. So little bit of adjustment. I know my pal sitting next to me, the guy who doesn't have a T-shirt with his picture on it, was not enamored of that move of putting Bedard in the bumper spot, but nevertheless.
Bobby, I still hate it. Just think about it. Your best player standing there looking around for a decoy and maybe the odd bumper pass. That's not what you're supposed to do with the best player. You can't argue with the two goals, but if I'm him, I'm like, that's enough of that.
And we remind you that there's a direct relationship in recent years between having the best power play in this tournament and winning the gold medal. In fact, six of the last seven gold medal winners have had the top power play, and most of them over 40%, including the three Canadian golds, well over 40%. 6 for 10 so far, 60%.
By the way, I don't have the number in front of me, but that American power play so far in this tournament has been very, very good.
Right. Let's face it, when some of these lopsided games early, the power play numbers can get skewed.
Inflated.
Ridiculous numbers. We'll see what happens come quarterfinals, semifinals, and so on and so forth. Sens fans are excited this offseason. They've had quite the summer. Claude Giroux, Alex DeBrincat. Shane Pinto is going to be back this year from injury. So I don't know where there is room, but Ridly Greig looks like he's almost ready for an NHL roster.
Well, one of the luxuries of sitting up here is there's a lot of experts that come by, and talking to some of them, everybody has a differing opinion on where Greig should play last year. I don't know how he doesn't play for the Ottawa Senators. Every time he's on the ice, he's very smart and he's a game breaker and takes advantage of simple situations like this. Offensive zone faceoff, he knows he's got his defender in a bad position and he's got an advantage to get to the net. This is just one of those plays when you're smart, a simple play off of a faceoff leads to an odd man advantage and an open ice opportunity like that. He's been fantastic for Canada, James.
Well, he certainly has. I mean, his just his ability, that the puck just finds him, and that's not by chance. And one of his line mates that's also playing extremely well today, that's going to be William Dufour. The New York Islanders must be very happy with their prospect. This guy had 116 points in the regular season with St. John. He was the MVP at the Memorial Cup with 7 goals. But he is showing his good hands and his vision. He recognizes everyone is on him here, uses the weak side of the ice. Cormier jumps in. He's using his body along the wall, being physical below the goal line. When you're a big man, you have to use it. But he turns everyone towards him and then uses his instincts to make those plays. And on the PK, he's used there. His first 5 strides are quick. He gets on the breakaway. Is it unable to convert? He probably wants that one back. He's used to converting. As we know, he had 56 goals this season with St. John. But again, just beating his player. And that guy is not easy to beat with that leverage. Good job by William Dufour. The entire line been so effective throughout this game.
Quick comment on both Dufour and Greig. First off on Dufour. Not the fastest skater in the world, but he's really improved it and picked it up. What we've been looking in this tournament was to see, does his stride break down at any point? More games, fewer numbers of days, but we haven't seen that at all. He's still got lots of jump in his step, moves very well for a big man. And to, on your point on Ridly Greig, there will be a temptation to get him right into the Ottawa Senator lineup, but I've got to believe that the Senators also think if you use the Josh Norris model, that is, start him in Belleville and get him some time there and then ease him into the lineup later.
One of the big stories coming into this tournament for Canada was the fact they would be missing their two top defensemen from December, Owen Power and Caden Gooley. So Olin Zellweger and Donovan Zabrango step up to be the top pairing and have been really terrific so far. What have you liked today?
Well, you know, Zabrango is going to play defensive hockey between the dots. He's going to push everything to the perimeter, be tough in front of the net. But Olin Zellweger, I mean, we're seeing his efficient skating. He has 3 assists in this game, and this is not by chance. He has an ability on the blue line to be able to recognize how to get to the middle of the ice and get the shot through. He also shrunk the zone earlier in that play. Again, just the ability of him, not just to one time, but open up, know exactly where he needs to be on the ice. He's so effective. He has the ability to draw coverage to him. It's by no mistake that he crosses the midline of the ice. He knows he's drawing players to him when he puts that pass on the stick. And then the ability to distribute, not only that, but to transport. Use the net to come up, a simple effective pass, follow it up for a shot on net. So the awareness of what lane to take is something that he also does very well.
Still a ways to go in this game, but you know, the big four in this tournament without Russia here, the U.S. dominated Sweden last night. The score was 3-2, but for 55 minutes they were dominant. Canada dominating Finland so far in this one, a 5-1 score through two periods. And we have some breaking news. Our cameras have located in the crowd O-Dog, a rare sighting, an entire row.
Yes!
A litter of O-Dog puppies. Together, look at them. Look at their excitement.
That's the best.
It's finally happened,
buddy. I was just going to make
alone.
A comment where I was
You're
so mad because I know you did that. But now I like you again because you probably did that too. Did you do it?
I had nothing to do with it. I don't control what fans wear. I'm not that powerful, though.
something.
I love you. I love you again, pal, and I'll look for your golf balls in the fescue again tomorrow.
You're getting no love from the producer, Bill, here. Our shirts were real. Those were staged.
Okay, thanks for that.
O-Dog and the O-Dog fans enjoying a 5-1 Canada lead through two periods of play. One game already done today, and it was basically the start of the elimination round because for Switzerland and for Austria, the loser of this one went home. The winner onto the quarterfinals. We'll show you what happened next. In the top 70s, still playing in the FedEx Cup playoffs. Here's the earlier game today. Austria-Switzerland, pretty simple. Winner goes to the quarters, loser goes home. Tied at one in the second. Tight game after controlling the puck along the boards. Fabian Ritzmann goes hard to the net. Shot is stopped by Jonas Tybel. Potts the rebound and the Swiss have a 2-1 lead. But final seconds of the frame. David Reinbacher keeps the puck into the blue line. Tosses it on net. Tipped in by Ian Scherzer. And Austria hanging around. They just keep it in at the blue line. And we are even heading to the third period of play. So 5 minutes into the third. 5 minutes left in the third. Tybel gets cross-checked in the boards there by Lorenz Lindner. That is a massive mistake because it's a five-minute major, a game misconduct. And so they're shorthanded for the rest of the hockey game. Less than 50 seconds into the man advantage. Attilio Biasca will come up with a loose puck, backhanded home, and that's the goal that sends Switzerland to the quarterfinals. Tough way to lose for Austria on that major penalty, but their tournament is done. So here's the way it looks. We know this much. The winner of this game between Canada and Finland will play Switzerland because Switzerland is locked in and fourth. Austria done. The U.S. have won the group. They are playing Czechia in the quarterfinals. Tonight, Sweden plays Germany here on TSN. The winner of that game finishes second. The loser will finish third. Which makes this a relevant game if you're into the whole matchups thing. So as mentioned, the winner of this game will play Switzerland and the loser will get a tougher game in Sweden or Germany. Latvia is locked into third position, and again Czechia will face the Americans in the quarterfinal. Slovakia, disappointing performance in this World Juniors as they are done. No disappointment for Canadian fans so far. A 5-1 lead headed towards the third period here in Edmonton, Alberta at the Summer World Juniors. Our friends at SportLogic now have it at 18-8 in favor of Canada for slot shots from that goal-scoring area, and 5-1 in goals so far as the Canadians dominate Finland through two periods of play. Your second period scoring summary, Mason McTavish now with 7 goals. That is 3 more than anybody else in the tournament. A couple of Americans are tied at 4 each, so he's dominant as he leads the goal-scoring race and the point-scoring race here at the World Juniors. The third period now with Gord Miller and Mike Johnson.
You know, Mike, when you started the tournament, you might not have talked about Ridley Gregg at the top of the list of guys that would be key for Canada, but he has been so far.
He really has. He's established his role, and he's come to be the guy that Dave Cameron leans on when setting the tone for the game. And right from the opening faceoff, Ridley Gregg said, you know what? I am here to play for keeps. And he and his line have been fantastic throughout. And they were initially tasked with, yes, you got to take Aturatu's line off the board and play good defense, but you think about the offense that they've created along the way, whether it's that goal, the power play goal for Forrester. DeForest had multiple looks, multiple breakaways. Waz picked up more points again. They have been a catalyst at 5-on-5 to tilt in the ice decidedly in Canada's favor in the second period. And it wasn't meant to be like that. They kind of got together in the middle of the second game of the round robin, but they have been pivotal to Canada's 5-1 lead and strong second period.
William DeFore, the Memorial Cup MVP, and a couple of breakaways in that second period. Ridley Gregg's played on the edge for a while. He got suspended.
Yeah.
After an NHL preseason game, got suspended in Brandon for a while.
Hit the red.
He's a gamer. You know, he's just a hockey player. He just gets involved.
Johnson got knocked off the puck for a moment. Puck loose at the line and picked back up by Tyson Forrester, who scored a key goal in this game. Power play marker in the first period. Stankoven dealt it down by Puccio. Still to come tonight, Sweden and Germany will battle. Sweden coming off that loss last night to the United States, which clinched first place in Group B last night. Johnson off the skate of Forrester out the center ice to McTavish as Canada changes. This is McTavish along with Joshe and Kulik.
Secondary checking role. They're trying to roll kind of two checking lines, and then McTavish can double shift with an offensive line as well. Better be paying attention to the bench because you're having some unusual combination with Dave Cameron picking defense to start the third.
Cormier with it, knocked down by Vero. And Asami. Back to Brad Lambert. Lambert was benched by the Finns for the entire third period of their game against Slovakia after taking a penalty that cost them a goal in the second period. Now picked up by McTavish, trying to poke that ahead. Gauthier finds it, McTavish in with Cooley. McTavish walks in and shoots. He whistled that wide. Shot that was.
I saw the net ripple on the outside of the post by McTavish.
In comes Joel Matta. Walks in, drops it back. And that shot by Yarmolenko that was blocked by Sabrango. That took a bite out of Donovan Sabrango. Another shot that's deflected high by Matta. And the puck goes up and out of play. And Sabrango shaking up at the end of that sequence.
Some of those expressive. We see Mace McTavish as he's disappointed he didn't finish the shot. Yeah, he does get the outside of the net. And he's slowing down. Not really looking to pass, but allowing his winger to freeze the goaltender before electing to shoot. Short side. He's played an awful lot in this game as well.
Puck bank down and icing called against Canada. And Mason McTavish is climbing the ranks for Canada. Leads the tournament in goals. Second in assists, leads in points. He had a plus +7.
That was the plus minus. I mean, you gotta think, the all-time record for Canada is 18 in the tournament. Does have a point potentially producing quarterfinal matchup available.
Might have one, yeah.
But what will matter is the fact that he's producing against a good team. Right? Got 1-1 against Finland. It's going to get tougher against Sweden in the U.S. and Finland again in the semifinals.
Zellweger lays that back. John Anderson and Dale McCourt share the Canadian record for most goals in one World Junior. They had 10 each in the first IHF World Junior back in 1977.
John Anderson.
Yeah.
I frequent his burger joint in Toronto. Great burgers.
You know, maybe not what he wants to be best known for.
Well. In Scarborough.
He comes here, but he shoots. He fires that wide.
That one in the mesh. This one will get blown dead if they score here because that ripple
puck went over the glass.
Over the glass.
Niemela knew it. Kind of looked back at the referee. Here's Niemela back with it. Ratu back to Niemela. Shoot, score! Hit by Hirvonen, and so this is going to come into play.
This will not count.
The Canadians are arguing right away.
And they're telling the referees. They know Dufour and Roy are right on it. I can see it clear as day right in front of us. So this will take a moment to sort through. This point shot tip in front by Campbell. And a beautiful tip to get it past the goaltender, but Canadian bench will see this quite quickly that to the left of Dylan Garand, the puck went into the mesh. Got to find a look that they can see before they can challenge
so
it.
So this is not the same as an offside challenge. You won't have the same kind of look.
And there's only how limited how long it's. I saw it. It's right in front of me. I said it during the play.
No.
I didn't think it would actually matter because they would score. But this puck went into the mesh, and they're going to take a look.
Team Canada, coaches challenge for missed stop it or play.
Okay, so here's the wrister. So that's the one. Hirvonen puts it in off a stick. And we need to see it to get up, though. I mean, you see it drop down. You see Niemela. Look at Niemela's body language. He knows the play is over because he saw it go in the mesh. He stopped playing. That's not going to be conclusive enough. We need to see it hit the mesh
and
ripple it. And if we don't have a look at it, then they can't take it away, even though they should. Again, Ridley Gregg stopped playing as well. Watch 17 on Canada. He doesn't bother trying to play the puck on the boards because he knows. He's just, look at Gregg. He's like, I don't really need to dig in here because puck hit the mesh. But until they find a shot that shows it, and Ridley Gregg going back. Yeah, play's over. So all the circumstantial evidence is pointing very clearly that the players on the ice knew that this was out. Now the referee on the back wall, and Greg's there, hang on, he goes right to the bench, we're fine. The referee on the back wall went into the mesh right over top of his head. So it's a lot harder to look up over top of you and see it because his back's against the boards right in front of him. We have a great angle. It's 70 feet from us and was very clear to me that it got into the mesh.
And a complicating factor, apparently the monitor on the at the timekeeper's bench has died.
I
thought they were picking up something. I didn't know you could be. That's why we got the challenge. Hey, Daddy, how's it going, eh?
They're talking. There it is. You know that was out.
Greg is talking to the Finns.
Yeah.
We both stopped playing.
That's what Rapp just said. We both stopped playing. You know that was out. That was really Greg saying, you know that was out. Sorry, he was talking to Atu. So they kind of acknowledge right there that the players on the ice saw it, but this doesn't show me.
Right.
Everybody, Ratu, Greg, Niemela, all the guys who had the line of sight to it going out, stopped playing. That's Ratu right there. Yeah, no one. But until they see it, I don't know if there's a...
I don't think
some sort of shot from the far end from somewhere.
They have a blue line camera that we don't have, so this may be inconclusive. Let's call the goal on the ice.
It's not inconclusive. It's unavailable. Right? I mean, like, there's some parts that, you know, whatever, for whatever reason, is it the blind spot?
So now the monitor's loading.
Look at the monitor. It looks like it's a spreadsheet right now. So I'm not sure that's going to help anybody with anything. And, you know, it's 5-2 if this counts. We're only 3 minutes into the game.
In the third period. Yeah, and I think, you know, and also going forward,
you don't want this to happen in a elimination situation, a gold medal winning situation.
So what's happening now is with the video problem, we're told the video goal judge upstairs, the video judge is telling them what he sees.
It should not take long to relay the message either. I can't find a replay that shows it, or I found a replay that shows it and it's out.
Right.
So it's not a very complicated explanation. There's no rules interpretation here. It's just, did it get into the mesh or not? And it did. The fact of the matter is it did.
We both saw it.
I said it middle of the game.
Okay, so here's the call being made, sort of.
I think it might count in the end.
I think it probably will count because I don't think there's no look that says the puck hit the mesh.
They don't trust my word, apparently.
And one more conference with the linesman. Here's the call from Christopher Holm.
After video review, the call on the ice stands. It's inconclusive. No bench minor penalty. The call is inconclusive upstairs.
So, Canada not penalized here for the unsuccessful challenge because there's no look at it.
I'm having a hard time swallowing that. Like, it's almost like they're, you know, well, we couldn't show it one way or the other, so we're not going to penalize you.
Well, the goal by Kemmel will count.
The goal will count, a really nice tip. But I don't know, like, rules are rules. It should be a penalty on Canada. Like, too bad there's no view of it. That's a tough break. And Greg knows right away that it went out. But a little test in adversity for Canada here. React to something not going their way.
That's an interesting interpretation of inconclusive. So what? Now,
I don't like that at all because it just opens up gray areas.
We all know you don't like that.
No. Too bad. You challenged. It didn't work. Should be a penalty. Even if it should have worked.
So 7 minutes after
And this is probably what Finland's talking about. Like, why is there not a penalty here? They challenged. They were wrong. Play was not overturned. Why don't we get a why? Hey, he challenged down there. He was wrong. Play goal counted. Why is it not a power play?
Penalty keeps saying why.
That's what he's asking. The same question I'm asking.
Unbelievably said. Because this would be a key point. If Canada up 5-2 and then go shorthanded against a lethal finish power play. Kemmel lays it back down and Ratu comes back out. Ratu for Kemmel. Throws that towards the goal. In comes Kemmel. Shoots.
Into the mesh.
That's out.
Okay, so apparently it is protocol. If the call is inconclusive, it does nullify the penalty for being wrong on a challenge. But not surprisingly, the top line for Finland strikes again. That was Kemmel with his third of the tournament, and they've done the bulk of the scoring for Finland. And strike again to try to draw Finland back in this game.
In comes Kapanen. Can't get a shot away. Off the mask of Garand, losing the side of the goal. Glad we showed the combined goals and not combined points.
That's what we're here for.
Combined points for a line is one of the worst stats going. That puck was played with a high stick and play is called.
And it's important for Canada to park that decision that didn't go their way
right. And
get back to playing. And don't play in your own end. And chance right here. Ooh. Off Sabrango's stick, off the helmet, and out the back door. Canada, just go back to work with what you did all second period, what you did to start the third period as well, to get the big lead.
Canada will have the choice for the quarterfinals on Wednesday, should it win this game. And will likely choose the third quarterfinal slot. Starts at 10 o'clock local time on Wednesday.
Yeah, I mean,
what's your pregame meal for a 10 o'clock game? Not spaghetti at 7 a.m., I hope.
Sleep. Just sleep and come to the game.
Mike Johnson, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, the thought of a 10 o'clock game in the morning, actually, the look on his face was a sheer horror. Yeah.
That's exactly right.
Hero shoots over the glass it out. That's why you stop playing minor hockey.
That's it. That's another high slot tip there for Finland.
Yeah.
It's a couple times. Kemmel just scored a goal like that. That time it was Mainpa getting a stick on the point shot. And they sliding up into the hash mark area, trying to drag the Canadian defenders away from their net, keeping their sticks available.
Here's Putio. Had that knocked away as Gauthier came in, and Ostapchuk ran into Puglio. Simon Taibel brings it back out. Kasper Simon Taibel, LA Kings third round pick, goes up towards the goal, and a big hit there by Gauthier as he belted down Roope Järventi. And Järventi, not too pleased about that, might have lost a chicklet on the play.
Did he get him into the curved dasher? That's supposed to soften the blow of these kind of collisions. Fourth and out there banging around, trying to reestablish some energy. Bills got a little quiet here. Bench got quiet with that early goal by Finland. And that idea of keep skating, keep making plays. Keep skating, keep making plays. If you do that, game will head right back the other way. Really, Greg again just chucking Ratu around on faceoff.
Stolen over here, but it's a great pass for Kimmel. And Duran got a piece of that. Ratu back down to Kimmel. Here, but it tips in the back of the net. And Kimmel has it back. Kimmel drops it off for Ratu. Feeds that back at the point. Penalty coming to Canada. Scooped up by Waugh. And with 14:44 to go in the third period, a high sticking call will go to Canada as Kimmel was clipped. And they're going to check and see. It'll be a 2-minute minor to Donovan Sobrango.
Seven black, 2-minute minor, high stick.
Sobrango, best defensive defenseman for Canada, goes to the box. As that first line went to work in the offensive zone, buying some time and drawing a penalty. Here you see, Sobrango gets kind of caught across the neck, more than the face, but enough to draw the penalty and an important kill now for Canada.
Tim throw for one of the power play. There's a shot by Ratu and it's snagged by Garand.
A little tension in the building now for
Canada. Friends don't let friends be goalie parents. Here's Garand with a save on the Finnish power play.
Rides up his pad before snaring it out. And I can breathe now, says Dad. Yeah, it would be tough being a goaltender parent.
So if you're a goalie parent, when you walk out of the rink, the best outcome is that nothing happened.
I would find it exhausting to watch one of my kids play net in any sport, let alone in a tournament with the stakes like this one. I'm tired for them.
McTavish won that faceoff. And on the backhand to the line, but not out. Niemela. Ratu. Rink wide. That shot fired wide by Putil. Ratu. Back down to Hirvonen. Ratu goes rink wide. Putil to Niemela. And Putil miscued that, put it wide. Now Simon can't clear it out. Simon Taivo. Bumped there by McTavish. It's picked off in front by Gauthier and played down the ice by Thompson. To 20, the shots on goal in favor of Canada. Finns on their second power play, down 5-2. Kimmel throws that rink wide.
Yeah, that's a foul.
Cooley knocked down Maienpää, and so now the Finns will be 5-on-3 for a minute and 1 second.
That's a bad decision by Cooley. Trying to step up on a shifty forward. It's so difficult to time that perfectly, and if you don't, you're going to get a penalty. It's just hard to check that way. So Cooley trying to challenge at the blue end. They're getting together, having a little chat about whether or not this could be five, perhaps. Is it a knee on knee? Oh, it is. And actually, you know what? That is a pretty strong knee on knee. I would not surprise me to see if they go five review.
Which is the default. You can call a five, video review it, and take it down to a two if you want. You cannot take a two and upgrade it to a five.
Previous play is under review for a major penalty.
Wow. So they've called the five, and they're going to take a look at it. It's a knee on knee. Now,
we saw the fifth major penalty in game misconduct called in the early game between Switzerland and Austria. It led to the game-winning goal by the Swiss.
And just food for thought as this is going on, the number one unit had just finished a minute in the power play. Would have been tired.
Right.
Now they'll be well rested for the 5-on-3 and perhaps lengthy 5-on-3.
A couple of points here. One, in the IHF, the outcome doesn't matter. How badly you're hurt doesn't matter. It's the action that gets reviewed. Secondly, they are more vigilant at this level than they might be at the senior level. They're more protective of teenage players than they would be at, say, at the World Championship.
Oh, I like my knees at 25-year-old, too.
Well, I understand that, but...
Yeah, listen, taking all that into consideration,
The defense of Cooley would be he wasn't skating forward very fast. Like, he's kind of standing still, lunging, as opposed to skating into a guy and having a really violent knee-on-knee collision. But he sticks his left leg out. And that, to me, is the knee. When you stick it out, it's trouble.
Robert Hennessy with the call.
After further review, we have a major penalty on the play for kneeing.
Yeah.
Five-minute major.
Wow. It's third period. Just got very interesting. So Cooley's out of the game. Got to get somebody else in the box.
So now, a 5-on-3 for 1:01. And a 5-minute major penalty against a team that came in 8-for-13 on the power play. And suddenly 5-2 doesn't look so comfortable.
And you think that the second goal was a goal that should not have counted.
Right.
So now, you know, as this plays forward.
Now they set it up Niemela. Back across to Putio. That top line goes back to work. Ratu, Putio, Niemela, Hirvonen. Hirvonen drops it back. Putio shoots for that save, and he's got the loose puck. Poked it after the whistle. Del Mastro in there, along with Greg. So these penalty killers getting a workout for Canada.
Durant gets across to make a good save. This seam pass right here is a tough one. That's a good look. And Durant squeezed it. He knows it's in there somewhere. He knows he's dropping it, and it falls between his legs, but the whistle clearly had went. And Durant wants a whistle faster than that.
Now, the two Finnish defensemen came up into the scrum. As a result, the faceoff comes outside.
That's a bad call. Puglio's putting the puck in the net. He's not in the scrum. He's putting the puck in the net. Not scrumming it up with anyone. Niemela's hanging around the hash marks. That's a break for Canada.
This is across to Hirvonen. The Finnish captain plays it back to Niemela. Niemela to Putio. Ratu to Putio to Niemela. Hirvonen back at the point. Shot that's blocked by Greg. And that's staggered Ridley Greg. Hirvonen plays it back across. Putio fronted that line. Hirvonen back on it. Ridley Greg's really stinging for that blocked shot. Racing back is Niemela. 15 seconds to go on the first penalty. Hirvonen. In the corner with it. Hirvonen. Walks out. Tied up by Greg. Ratu plays it back in front. Ratu shoots. He fires that wide. Sabrango set to step back on the ice. Niemela to Ratu. Sabrango steps back on. Niemela shoots. Blocked in front again by Greg. Rebound. Fired wide by Niemela. What a shift for Ridley Greg. Barely able to stand up now. Niemela, Ratu feeds it back across. Putio blocked the front by Greg. Rebound put wide. And now Del Mastro falls on it. Finland still on the 5-minute major power play.
Good play, good patience.
Del Mastro to Greg, and Sabrango sends it off. And every Canadian player standing for Ridley Greg. And the fans too. Took down Himasami. He thought he was getting one. Kimmel, rink wide, picked off by Gaucher and sent down the ice. Five, two, Canada leads. Finland on a long power play that included a 5-on-3 for over a minute. Kimmel chips it in. Kimmel, drops that back. Himasami, the Jarvinti, feeds it back in front. That was disrupted by Ostapchuk. Ostapchuk plays it back, tosses and fires it back down the ice.
Good recovery by Ostapchuk, putting some pressure on the point, and then getting back to cover the seam pass.
McTavish back out there. Here's Hirvonen, being tracked by the Canadian captain. For Simon Tavel. Drops that back for Hirvonen. Hirvonen, that's picked up by Gaucher and sent back down the ice. He'll move off, and Greg steps back on. Simon Tyvel lines in across the line, drops it back to Hirvonen. That pass broken up. by Dufault. Picked up by Seeley and sent back down the ice. Inside two to go with a five-minute major. And the Emelet swings back to pick it up. The top defenseman of the 2021 World Junior Championship, Tuppy the Emelet. Feeds it back for Ratu to Hirvonen. Ratu back on it. And that puck was off the stick of Kapanen. Up and out. 10:21 to go here in the third period. Kemmel the goal. That was in controversial circumstances, but it counts. And Canada's lead cut to three.
Really, Greg, the center of attention on that 5-on-3 penalty kill and putting his body on the line. Desperation time right off his heel. Great shot block there. He was staggered, but he did not leave the ice. He hangs in there, trying to draw penalties, trying to get in the way, doing anything he can to get this power play killed off. And it's a really gutsy effort by him. That even the glove save attempt by gets Brendan Hoffman's attention to the penalty box. Got the guys in the bench banging their sticks. And they recognize the kind of sacrifice he just put out there killing the penalty. And best part about it, he was out there the next shift as well.
I think there might be some people in Ottawa smiling about that too.
He's been full value. A lot about him in Ottawa and the prospect he is. He is.
And Masami plays it back across. Kimmel shot, that time blocked by Sabarenko. Now picked up by Gaucher. Lead pass to McTavish. In shorthanded, Mason McTavish works it. He and Masami collide. McTavish trying to pick that free. And now brought out by Kimmel.
Joachim Kimmel. Ottawa and the prospect he is. He is.
And Masami plays it back across. Kimmel shot, that time blocked by Sabarenko. Now picked up by Gaucher. Lead pass to McTavish. In shorthanded, Mason McTavish works it. He and Himmelselmi collide. McTavish trying to pick that free. And now brought out by Kimmel. Joachim Kimmel drops it off for Mata. Kimmel centers it. And Kapanen flashed on that. Jarventi works that back across to Kimmel. Skipped away from him for a moment. Minute to go in the five-minute major. Himmelselmi. Back across to Jarventi, in shoot. That was blocked by Thompson. Jarventi centers it. Kimmel had to skip off his stick again. Here's Kimmel back with it. Drops it back to Himmelselmi. Back for Kimmel. Has time and shoots. That's blocked by Sabarenko off his hand. That took a bite out of him. Another chance, and Jarventi put it high and wide, and Sabarenko.
He's in trouble here. He got that open palm on his fingertips. It's trouble.
36 seconds to go in the five-minute major. It's still 5-2. FedEx Cup playoffs continue. Catch the third round of the BMW Championship 3 Eastern Noon Pacific on TSN and CTV2 on Saturday.
Canada trying to work off the end of this five-minute major. Sabarenko open palm and it's just so easy to break your fingertips when you get your glove facing the wrong way. Maybe got a little bit more palm than fingertip, which might be a good thing. And he was feeling that.
So the face-off in the Canadian zone, 36 seconds to go. In the NHL, you don't go to a TV timeout during a power play, but in the IHF rules, during five-minute majors, you can.
So Finland's had two TV timeouts during this five-minute major. In full rest for their number one unit. Back on the ice they go. Sabarenko had an ice bag on his left hand.
So Ratu for the face-off against McTavish. Boy, Mason McTavish has played a load here today.
Seems like McTavish and Greg are out there every other shift.
Off the face-off win, set down the ice by Dufour. 30 seconds to go in this long power play. Included a minute and one of 5-on-3. Lead pass for Ratu in across the line. That looked offside.
Close.
Ratu drops it back to Niemela. Cross to Puglio. Skipped off his stick. Seeley racing to it. Del Maestro gets to it. Now picked up by Greg. On his backhand. A tough play. So Greg just eats the puck for a moment. Hirvonen. Back for Niemela. To Puglio walking in the pass off his skate. Final seconds now of this power play. Puglio with it. and they kill it off. On comes Hoffman. The shot hit and blocked, and Hoffman's away, along with Dufour. Hoffman's flush just spent 5 minutes in the penalty box, but the play's offside at the finish blue line, and what a job by the Canadian penalty killer.
Bailing out their teammate, rising to the occasion, recognize the importance of the moment, and digging in.
And the
all
Finns,
across the board.
And the Finns did not have a shot in the final 4 minutes of that power play.
So at 5-on-4, they did not have a shot. Only at 5-on-3. It was a minute 5-on-3 to start that penalty. What a great job on the defensive group. They had a whole bunch of forwards here for Canada trying to get back into the game.
Right,
in the last 8.5 minutes.
Haven't seen Bedard for a while, obviously. Here's Forster on it. Rolled away from him. Samuel Vero plays it in. Vero spins back. Lambert kicks at it. And moved out by Stankoven. Vero plays it around to Hamasami. Up for Hellenius. Surprised they don't use Hellenius on the power play just to stay in front of the goaltenders. 6'6", 220 pounds.
You see, Zdeno Chara down in front of the net at times. Same idea.
In comes Johnson with an out. Kent Johnson winds in. Shoots from a sharp angle. Saved made by Marilyn. Rebound. And Stankoven turned away. Brought out now by Lambert. Goal to come next. Sweden and Germany. In the battle for second place in Group B. That sharp angle shot by Lambert. Knocked away by Garand. Pass bounces back to Cormier. Cross it goes to Zellweger. Cormier up for Johnson. And Johnson winds in. And the puck poked free by Yermo. Johnson will get it right back to the point. He goes to Rourke with a shot. Marilyn and save. Benway on the forecheck that's knocked by him. By Pudio. O'Rourke snaps that pass into Denoye. Carolina had the pass disrupted on the forecheck by Hoffman. Simon Taivo sends that rink wide. Picked up by Gauthier, who drops it back to Del Mastro. And he finds Seeley with it. 6.5 to go here in the third period. Del Mastro. Up ahead to Dufour that chips down to Marilyn and leaves it there for Niemela. Open Niemela. Push pass ahead for Hirvonen. Hirvonen tries to play it across, bouncing back for Ratu, and Hirvonen hacked the rebound wide. Del Mastro lost his stick as Ratu falls. A penalty coming to Canada. It'll be a trip to Ethan Del Mastro. Finland back to the power play. 5:55 to go here. In the third period, it's the final day of the preliminary round of the World Junior Hockey Championship 2022 here in Edmonton.
Canada back to the penalty kill. Here's more Ridley Gregg. You want to talk about a stacked stuff in Canada night? He has been all over it. Face-off, hits, block passes, block shots, chirps. You name it, he's got a goal, he's got an assist, he's got a little bit of everything for Canada against Finland. And here in the third period, when they've been doing a lot of defending, he has been doing a fantastic job with that. Enough to keep his teammates' attention and maybe even smile on his dad. Mark, former NHLer, scout for the Flyers, got his Flyers gear on there. And he'd be pretty proud of how his son has played this one, that's for sure.
Latu centers it. Kemmel rather centers it.
DeBrango back out there. It's a good sign for Canada.
After blocking that shot earlier with his hand. Hamasami works it on the power play. Feeds it back across. Kemmel, hard shot. Grand the save.
No
his
helmet.
Mask, and his mask is.
He said it by straps off. Like, look at it, ref. Come on. You're right behind him.
So his mask has become.
Yeah, but. So. You gonna make him flick it off? I mean. If you're standing right behind him, as Robert Hennessy is.
And he said, why don't you blow it right away?
We can see it. You can hear it. You can watch the two straps. You see them flopping around in the back. Tells you, you're right behind them. You're right there. Why would you not blow this down? There it is. The strap is right there.
The strap of the mask is off, so.
Yeah.
Face off, one by a stop check, and the puck set back down the ice.
You got to get the Dwayne Rollison neck roll. Just snap it off anytime you want.
I think
shrug of the shoulders, helmet comes off.
He could scratch his head and have that thing come off. Away comes Hirvonen. Back across to Simon Teibel. Niemela. Plays that back in. Puthio plays it down to Hirvonen. Ratu back for Niemela. Rocket shot that goes wide. Niemela back for Ratu. He mishandled the puck, but it's moved out by Desmoyer. 45 seconds to go in this finished power play. Another penalty coming to four is going to go off. Holy. So it's going to be a 5-on-3 for 29 seconds here.
Not making life easy on themselves to finish this game off is Canada.
Team Canada, 25 minor tripping.
Yeah, you reach like that, and that's, you know, you get it between the legs and a crossover. They're going to fall every time. It's going to be a penalty every time. And 29 seconds on a 5-on-3. If Finland's able to get one before the first penalty expires. And this was a power play coming in this game that was clicking along at 62%. Not the group you want to keep putting out there.
It was lethal. Much tougher competition here. Järventie plays it back. Emil Salmi works it back in. Kimmel off the outside of the post. This power play got them back in the game against Czechy when they were down 2-0. Emil Salmi fired it wide. Want to win that game in a shootout. Emil Salmi wanders in, feeds it across. Kimmel walks it and shoots. Little leg in front. The Brangle back on it. 5-on-3 almost over, and now is as Del Mastro steps back on. Emil Salmi feeds it across. Kimmel floated that high and wide. So Canada kills off another two-man advantage for Finland. But a minute and a half of it here in the third period. Järventie swings it back. And the Finns are pulling their goaltender. Quick shot scores. Järventie. Just as the extra skater came on, it's a power play goal. Now 5-3 with 3:37 to go. So the Finns pull their goaltender. The player came on, wasn't a factor, but the goal is scored nonetheless by Robi Järventie.
Good job going through the seams. Right through. As part of the problem is here is you got Del Mastro out there, a defenseman, stepping out of the box and no idea what he's doing up top. You know, he's too high, he's not protecting the seam underneath, which is normal because he's not used to playing up there. And Brand gets it in his glove. Now he's upset he didn't squeeze that one in the glove and into the back of the net. And 5-3, 3:37 left. Plenty of time to keep pushing.
You think now about the 5-on-3s that got away for the Finns. That, you know, that not just the 5-on-3, but the 5-minute power play.
Yeah. If I'm Canada, I'm thinking, well, the goal that started this whole thing shouldn't have counted. So let's see if we can't grind this game to a conclusion.
Well, Canada has taken all four penalties here in the third period. Now a centering pass and a quick chance for Logan Stankoven, and a point-blank save made there by Marilainen.
Stankoven's been around and just can't find a back of the net for a guy who scored so much in the regular season, 45 with Kamloops. And C24 Del Mastro, so he's playing up top, and he gets dragged a little too high, and that allows the seam to go underneath. And Järventie, right in the glove. He's right there, he's trying to keep it outside the post, and it trickles in.
Faceoff won by Stankoven. Long shot by Thompson. He fired that high and wide. The line held by Zellweger. Rolling puck. He shoots that wide.
And if you're Canada, be aware if Finland gets a puck in the offensive zone for the goalie to come.
In comes Thompson. Shoots. That's punched away. We've barely seen Connor Bedard here in the third period.
Two shifts in this period, maybe.
All the penalty killing that's gone on. Johnson, rink wide to Forster, but it's called offside at the finish blue line.
So Canada trying to collect their breath, get those skating legs going. And I think at this point, given the score 5-3, and given the fact that Connor Bedard has been sitting there for basically the entire third period, I think Dave Cameron's elected to just kind of play three checking lines to finish off the game. I don't think we'll see Connor Bedard again. And Austin, same thing. He sat the 5 minutes. He's barely played. So the first two-line wingers haven't really played in the third period.
And you didn't get benched on purpose.
No, it's not for lack of just playing well. It's a function of game management and caution.
So icing here against Canada.
Time to go.
Back down. Do you think that?
Yep.
Yeah. So Coach Antti Pettinen is going to pull goaltender Leivi Marilainen with 2:32 to go. The faceoff in the offensive zone for the Finns. It'll be 6-on-5.
And you want to let him go now. Don't take your time out.
Ratu will take the faceoff against McTavish. Ratu wins that back. Here's Hirvonen. Hirvonen shoots off the skate of a stop chuck. Hirvonen shoots. And Duran got a piece of that. Helenius plays it back around for Putio. In comes Putio. Putio plays it down to Hirvonen. Six skaters on 5 for the Finns, broken up by Thompson. Niemela. Back for Putio. In comes Niemela. Ratu feeds it across to Putio. It shoots. He fires that wide. McTavish gets to it, just takes a two-handed whack at that. Empty net for a stop. Jeff gains center ice. Finds Dufour. Dufour in. Shoots. Scores. William Dufour. Empty net goal. And Canada's back up by 3.
Was it pretty? It was the four in the box when Finland scored their third goal. But he salts this one away with the empty netter. Here's Putio with his chance as Rand makes a good blocker save there. McTavish probably gets another assist here as he chops it up, and Stapchuk and DeFour kind of kick it around, take a couple slashes, and I'm all for being unselfish. But if you're DeFour, you're not trying to pass that to a Stapchuk. You gotta end this game. Put it in the middle of the empty net, get that 3-goal back, and say enough's enough.
William DeFour, native of Quebec City, is an Islander 5th-round pick. Led the Quebec League with 56 goals in 66 games, and then the Memorial Cup. Scored 7 times in 4 games. That's one off the tournament record for goals in one Memorial Cup. That's Dale Hawerchuk, Luke Robitaille, and Pat Palou. This game began with Finland dominating the first 5 minutes. And Canada poured it on. But in the third period, penalty trouble, some controversy. A goal by Finland that probably shouldn't have counted. A 5-minute major to Canada. And the lead got snug at 5-3, but now a 6-3 advantage.
Game of 3 different periods where the first one pretty even. Canada didn't play great, but they were opportunistic. Second period, Canada, maybe the best period they played all tournament, dominant, and then just kind of hung on. And on the third, penalty trouble. But they're going to get the win in the end. Mission accomplished.
Cormier winds and shoots. It goes off the shin pad of Helenius. 30 seconds to go here in the third. Johnson for Stankoven. Back to Kent Johnson. Stankoven to Johnson. Rolling puck. Feeds it back across. Just Forster with it. Tyson Forster scored a very big goal for Canada in the first period. The power play goal. Extended the lead. Connor Bedard scored a fantastic goal. It'll be talked about for days. As time winds down here in the third period. They knew it would be their toughest test yet. And it was. Canada wins it 6-3, a 4-0 record. And now advances to the quarterfinals. And And there, Canada will take on Switzerland on Wednesday. This is the day when the offensive stars were the story early on, and then the penalty killers, forwards and defense, became the story in the third period.
Need a little something from everyone to beat a good team. Finland's a good team, and everyone had a role to play, played it pretty well. And there'll be some stuff to work on, closing out games for Dave Cameron and the group, but grand, solid. And the good news for Canada is they probably feel they can play better and a more complete game than what they just played. And they were still able to win, secure first, whatever that means for your matchups, on into the quarterfinals.
Time now for the player of the game presentations and then the Canadian anthem.
The best player of each team is awarded a one-of-a-kind hockey stick, hand-painted by one of Canada's most prolific contemporary Indigenous visual artists, Jason Carter. The prizes will be presented by Mike Klein, owner and operator of Stellar Homes, warm-up partner of the IIHF World Junior Championship, and Sean Power, manager of terminal operations and security with Edmonton International Airport. The best player of Team Finland, et le numéro 21, number 21, Alexi Hemosalmi.
Hemosalmi, the defenseman, a second-round pick of Carolina. Was the top defenseman at the under-18 tournament last spring.
The best player of Team Canada, et le numéro 17, number 17, Ridley Gregg.
So this is chosen by the Team Canada management. They don't often pick the same player twice. Greg's already won one. How could you not?
Can't ignore him in this game. He played so well, instrumental offensively, penalty killing, checking line, face-offs, you name it, all over this game.
So now it's on to the quarterfinals on Wednesday.
Now please rise for the National Anthem of Canada. Maintenant, merci de vous lever afin d'écouter l'hymne national du Canada.
Finland made things a bit interesting down the stretch, but overall a dominant performance by Canada thus far. A perfect 4-0 record through group play. Sounds like Team USA maybe setting the stage for a matchup down the stretch. We shall see. NHL Tonight starts now.